known for. Wake up to Monday with the new look, Big Breakfast.
Welcome to the Big Breakfast. It's Monday, the 2nd of September, and I'm Rick Adams.
And would you believe it? I'm Sharron Davies.
And before we get on with this, I'll just get this chewing gum out and stick that there. There we go, Steve, you can hold on to that. And in fact, we're doing a live TV show here, so it certainly feels like Chief Inspector Dreyfus from, like, the Pink Panther. So that's why I look like this.
It's very electric and a little bit nerve-wracking.
So, let's take a look at our house. Of course, we've got a brand new Big Breakfast house.
And very, very nice it is, too.
Now, the Big Breakfast house used to look like this. Now, later on, of course, a week later, it looked a bit like this. And this is what it looked like last week. Well, actually, last night.
Well, actually, about 5 minutes ago, in fact, really.
And there it is. So now, they said it wouldn't be finished. They were foolish. They were stupid, because it has been finished. And let's take a look at the Big Breakfast brand-new house. Here it is.
Everyone has worked incredibly hard.
Please don't try and climb on their balcony like that. So there we are.
It's looking wonderful. Let's have a wander on through.
Take us inside, Shazza.
This is, as you can see, our front balcony, and we come in here for our galleried landing, needless to say.
Mm, very nice, too.
And this space here is extremely important for us. It's the lounge.
It's still wet.
Don't touch the sides. Or, as we call it, the den, and an awful lot goes on around here, but less of that. We will be doing a big tour of the house later on where we show you everything.
Right, well, let's tell you what's going on in today's show. First of all, rock god Noel Gallagher will actually be turning up to go to Snap. Also, Hollywood superstar Andie Macdowell will be here with a trowel, but she doesn't need it because we're actually finished here. And finally, millionaire lottery winner Carl Crumpton will be popping in and hopefully giving us loads of dosh.
Loads of dosh. But on the menu in the next 20 minutes. At 7:05, meet our brand new Eye in the Sky, the Big Breakfast helicopter. At 7:10, find out who's in the bed with Zig and Zag in the Crunch. And at 7:15, Richard Orford has a very special surprise for one lucky family. It could be you.
And he has a twinkle in his eye too, and so does this man. With the time at 7:02, it's time for us to pop over to Peter Smith for the Big Breakfast News.
Good morning. These are the main stories on Monday, the 2nd of September. The storm grows over Howard's decision to free two drug lords. England return this time. They're the conquering heroes. And a nightmare at the opera as storms lash Sydney. The fury over the Home Secretary's decision to free two heroin dealers won't die down. And now a leading retired judge has condemned it. John Hass and Paul Bennett have been released after serving just 12 months of their 18-year sentences. Home Secretary Michael Howard defends the decision, saying they'd shopped other dealers. But former Judge Michael Argyle branded the Supergrass system poisonous. There's been a hand grenade attack on the home of the parents of loyalist hardliner Alex Kerr. He's received death threats along with Billy Wright because of fears they plan to break the ceasefire. Mr. and Mrs. Kerr escaped serious injury. Iraq still controls the Kurdish safe haven it captured at the weekend. The country's defense minister says Saddam Hussein has told him to pull out their troops, but that hasn't happened yet. American forces in the Gulf are on red alert. Police hunting four-year-old Tom Loughlin are trying to establish the identity of a boy's body found in Norfolk. Tom and his sister Jodie vanished from a beach near Hunstanton 2 weeks ago. Jodie's drowned body was found nearby on Friday. Doctors treating Mother Teresa in Calcutta say she's now developed chest complications. She was being treated for malaria and heart problems, but new x-rays show dark patches on her lungs. The chaos in Britain's postal service continues. After Friday's strike by Royal Mail workers, there's another one today. Managers are furious that union leaders won't hold a fresh ballot on pay and conditions. Further strikes could trigger a 3-month suspension of the Royal Mail's monopoly. Kim Wilde is starting her first day as a married woman. The 35-year-old Tommy actress and co-star husband Hal Fowler are honeymooning at a secret British location. She's already keen to swap showbiz for motherhood, but has to be back on stage on Friday. The £15 million man Alan Shearer has scored in his first game as England skipper. The 3-0 win over Moldova gave them a successful start to their World Cup qualifying campaign. Nick Barmby got the opener, Paul Gascoigne the second, Shearer the third. But new coach Glenn Hoddle says the players can do better. He may be on the verge of a world championship, but Damon Hill will soon be out of a job. He'll need a seat elsewhere next season. He's been dumped by Renault team boss Frank Williams. It's not clear why, but Hill is already talking with other rivals. In Australia, fierce storms are causing chaos across Sydney. Floods are turning rivers into raging torrents, leaving many motorists stranded. 20,000 homes have lost power and emergency crews have received 6,000 calls for help after 72-mile-an-hour winds. Amazingly, no one's been seriously hurt. It's 7.05. We're back at 7.30. Here's Rick and Sharron.
Hello, Pete. It's nice to talk to you at long last. I always thought you were a bit of a hologram, really. I'm very well, actually. A little bit frightened and nervous, but having great fun.
Fantastic house. It looks stunning.
It's amazing. Are you a bit of a football fan?
A football fan, yeah. No. Everybody who watches this show knows I know nothing about football.
Nonsense, though.
Well, I know now.
When you walk into the building, it's a bit like Alan Shearer. Everyone goes, Peter Smith, there's a news god.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Thank you very much, Peter.
We'll be back to you later. Bye. We've got something very exciting to tell you now. Shall I tell them?
Yes, go on.
Okay. Right.
Very, very
well,
special.
Every day now, up until Christmas, actually, we're going to be bringing you a brand new service. Oh! A service with a smile, of course. We're going to be bringing you the weather and the travel in an interesting way. So from now on, there's no excuse to be late to school or work, even.
Well, what we're going to be doing now... I may stay home to watch it all and, you know, watch our very lovely...
Because it's so exciting, Denise. Sharron, isn't it? That's the case. Mm-hmm. And so is Sharron. OK, so this is what's going to happen. We're going to go over to our eye in the sky for the Big Breakfast helicopter.
Denise Van Outen, where are you?
Good morning, I'm in Newcastle, just hovering above Newcastle city centre. And at the moment, the weather here is pretty miserable, as you can see. It's very cloudy with lots of rain. Now, in the rest of the country, the temperatures are looking like this. There will be an average of 20 degrees, ranging from 18 degrees in Glasgow and Belfast to 22 degrees in Plymouth. As for chances of rain, well, it's going to be very wet in Glasgow. They have a 60% chance of rain. In Cardiff and Plymouth, it will remain dry. And the outlook? It's another mixed bag. In northwest Scotland, it's going to be cloudy with drizzle. In the east, it will also be cloudy. In southwest England and south Wales, you should have a nice dry day, quite warm with some sunshine. In north Wales, northern Ireland and southern England, it's going to be dry and warm with cloud. Now I have a big breakfast fact for you. Did you know that it was here in Newcastle that the first ever beauty contest was held on the 23rd of December 1905? But you didn't know that. Well, as for the traffic, in Newcastle at the moment, it's looking like this. Everything seems to be running quite smoothly, but in the rest of the country, it's good news in the West Midlands. The M6, M5, M42 and A38M are all fine in both directions. But in Merseyside, on the coastal road to Southport, there is local flooding, which means that the road is closed to avoid it possible. In Glasgow, the lights are out at Stockwell Street. And surprise, surprise, the M25 in Surrey, between junction 6 and 10, they have roadworks, so that means lane and speed restrictions. Now in London, the A40 on Holland Park Avenue is closed townbound due to a burst water main, so rush hour traffic will be moving very slow on the M41 and Shepherd's Bush roundabout. And at the A102M Blackwall Tunnel has roadworks on the northern approach, so expect long delays. Well, that's it from me, Denise Van, out and about in the Big Breakfast helicopter. It's back to Rick and Sharron.
Thank you very much, Denise. Did you have a big greasy breakfast this morning?
Oh, no, I couldn't. I'd be sick.
I thought so.
So she's in Newcastle, and thank you very much, Denise. We'll come back to you a bit later.
Thank
and if
you.
You're in Newcastle, please don't try and look up her skirt. She's wearing trousers, for goodness sake. That's what she's doing. Now, we have an exciting competition to tell you about to do with Denise.
This is extremely cool. I wouldn't have minded doing this when I was at school.
Now, you get a chance to sit in Denise's lap.
And you can't enter.
You can't actually, you have to be here working with me. Unfortunately, you have to be between the age of 5 and 14.
Any
30-year-old guys out there are going, oh, I can't believe it, which is a bit unfortunate. But what we're doing is our big breakfast helicopter competition. If you want to arrive in style at school, then what we're going to do is give you the opportunity so to do. And what you're going to do also is get the chance to read our final weather bulletin with Denise. In our chopper, which is good stuff. Now, all we've got to do, really, is complete this sentence with no more than 8 words. That's 8 words. Okay, now, the sentence goes like this. The Big Breakfast helicopter should take me for a ride because... Okay, so you've got to fill that in with no more than 8 words, please. Now we're going to need a few things from you, okay? Because it's a kind of two-way thing, isn't it, Sharron?
Oh, yes.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
So
interaction.
It is. That's what we like. Everybody interacting here?
It's good. Very good.
Yeah, they all had their caffeine, which is good stuff. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to need your name We're going to need your age, and there's no lying, we're going to check birth certificates. And also your address, phone number, permission from your parent or guardian, whoever's shielding you, from Denise. And also we need your school's address, we need the school's phone number, and also the name and phone number of your head teacher.
A lot of information.
That's about it, really.
I think we better show you the address style. That you have to write to.
Let's take a look.
Now you need to make sure you get that information into us by Wednesday. That is the 3rd of September, so get writing very quickly so we can judge the best.
Okay, but now it's time for our question of the day. Late, but it was there. Now, the question of the day basically is, it's a brand new show here, and of course we've had a few technical hitches. No, we haven't. Not yet, he says, touch wood. So hopefully nothing will go wrong, but things do go wrong and it's a bit horrible. And we want you to tell us about the fluffy, horrible times when things, domestic appliances or anything like that, have let you down. So tell us about your domestic technological disasters. So what we want you to do is give us a call, and the numbers are as follows. So let's see where they are now. Here it comes. Uh-oh. An exciting building site. And it's 01819851111. Or fax us on 01819852222. Another building site cleavage in sight.
But of course we've got some birthdays as well that we've actually forgotten, so we need to mention those.
You want to mention the birthdays?
Yes, of course.
Okay, if you want to, go for
very, very quickly.
Right, go.
Who have we got here? We've got Keanu Reeves.
Oh.
He's 32 years old today.
Right.
I was actually going to throw this out at speed, but I don't think
it's
going
to
just hit somebody. One of our crew will knock him out, so we'll do that.
And also, Jimmy Connors. It's his birthday. He's
Happy birthday, 44.
So, new balls, please. Well, listen, Sharron, I have to go.
Okay.
I'll see you.
Off you go.
Zig and Zag!
And he's off to the crunch. Now, this is Zig and Zag's first day. It's their brand new bedroom. And with them, they have a very special doctor. Yes, it's time for the crunch.
The crunch.
For goodness sake!
7-Eleven!
Makeup! How do I look? My first day. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, lads and lasses, small household pets and kitchen utensils. Welcome to our brand new, very expensive house and our brand new, very expensive bedroom.
Yeah.
Zig, show them around.
Yes, indeed. Yes, me and my brother have got a brand new bed. It's over there.
There it
over
is.
There. This is my side, that's my brother's side, over there is my side. Because I like to be side than loose.
And
we've got a brand new toy cupboard.
Yes, indeed, over
which
there.
Which is very
right behind
small.
You, Jerry, there.
Right
not
you,
Jerry. Me. Thank you.
Very small.
Yes. A brand new top-of-the-range TV with cable. Check it out.
Over there.
The Grey Bunny show's on now.
Yeah.
It's from Czechoslovakia. Don't get that, do you? Not really, no.
No!
Not many of you. And we've got, like, lots of foreign channels on that station.
Yeah.
It's great.
I mean,
Oh, wait.
Morning.
Ricky.
I'm your brand new TV presenter type, best mate type, lovely, handsome chap person. Yeah. My name... Yeah. No, seriously, thank you very much.
And a good morning to you, Rick.
Good morning to you, boys. Yeah. And, of course, my name is Rick Adams. I presume that you are familiar with my work.
We certainly are.
Never going to give you up. Never going to let you down. Never going to run around and desert you.
I mean, how could we not know it, Rick?
Look, boys. Just a second.
Yeah?
Let's interrupt you. No, my name's Rick Adams. It's not Rick Astley, is it? Rick Adams.
No.
Everything I do.
No, it's in the list. And it said,
I do it for
Rick
you.
Astley.
That's the one, isn't it?
The list.
No.
Zag.
All right, pack it in. It's Brian Adams. I'm Rick Adams.
All right.
I need to read a script,
so we don't know. We've never heard of you ever. Okay, so
move along.
It's your first day today, but it's also someone else's first day.
It is.
Tell us about it. Dr. Lawrence Gant.
Dr. Lawrence!
Come on in.
Wow,
have you got warm hands?
Oh, no, cold them especially.
Oh, I'm cool.
Now, some questions about your first day, Doctor.
Dr. Lawrence Gant, what sort of doctor are you?
I'm a casualty doctor.
Cool.
When was your first day? When was your first day? When did you start?
Well, my first day in casualty was actually up in Edgware, and that was actually 4 years ago. But I just started at the Homerton Hospital, which is just over the way.
Wow, cool.
So, if you're a bit nervous, do you have to be very careful? Because if you're stitching people, can you?
Yeah.
Well, you have to be a little careful, but, right. You know, you're well trained, so there's plenty of other people around, so you're not usually as petrified as people think.
Even on your first day?
Oh, yeah, you've got to be pretty.
And then, Dr. Lewis, you have affairs and stuff like that, like they do on TV.
Yeah,
on ER!
Yeah,
it's
for
the members of medical staff.
And he's not as hairy as George Clooney.
What's the worst moment that ever happened?
I think the worst thing on the first day is when you get the first real emergency come in. We had a very bad asthmatic come in who was really quite sick. Mm. And that's quite worrying at first.
Yeah.
But you've got lots of help around you, and the nurses are all very good.
I suppose the best thing was when that guy got cured.
Yeah, absolutely.
Don't get better, must be good.
No, they got completely better.
Excellent.
So that was excellent.
Rick, do a professional link.
America work.
Do a professional link.
A professional link.
Thanks, Dr. Lawrence, first.
Thanks,
Dr. Lawrence, first. This show's moving like a hot slot, this is.
Absolutely, and of course there's more from the boys at 7:20, because this is...
Never gonna.
To be continued.
It always looks such fun up there. I hope I get to go up there as well. Now, Richard Orford has got a brand new, exciting job. He's going to be spending the whole week with an entire family. And the fun thing is, at the moment, they don't know who it is. He's packed his suitcases, he's got his photograph of his mum with him. So, Richard, who's the family?
Ah, thank you very much, Sharron. Yes, indeed, it's Richard here. I'm out and about in Britain. I will reveal who the family is in a few seconds' time. Very exciting indeed. But I have to tell you that I will be spending a week with our family. It could be anybody. It could be out there. I could be doing it at any time, any moment. Very exciting indeed. And I'll be uncovering family secrets and finding out what they get up to, what they do, etc., etc., etc. I'll be moving in lock, stock, and barrel, as it were. Now, it's going to be one of three families today. Very exciting indeed. They've got no idea we're coming, and they haven't got a clue that we will be staying with them for the whole week. So who's it going to be? Is it going to be, par exemplar, the Montagues from Somerset? There they are, Montagues from Somerset. Panic. Or could it be the Turners from Yorkshire? It could be. Or finally, could it be the Bates from Hampshire? Let's go and find out now. Got my suitcase all packed, very realistic looking suitcase. Let's run down the street. The house is dead ahead, actually. We got here really late last night, about 1 o'clock in the morning, so I hadn't really had a chance to look around, as it were. But first impressions are very important. It looks a very nice street, actually, very nice area. Weather a little bit ropey, as Denise said in the chopper, actually. It's probably the same all over the place. But here's the house. We're about to meet them now. I can't exclusively reveal. It is the Turners from Yorkshire, and you, yes, you must be, let me think, Wendy.
Yeah.
Good morning, Wendy. How are you? Guess who's here for breakfast? It's me, yes. Believe it. Now, who else is around? Let's find out who else is in. So that's Wendy. Come in, guys. Wendy, and you must be Phil. That's Phil. He's the only son in the family. How are you, mate? You okay?
Great.
Lovely. Okay, you sit down, relax, get over the shock. And now over here we've got Catherine. Hello, Catherine. Now, you've got the TV on there, so you must have had a slight inkling we were coming, but did you have any idea before now that we were going to turn up at your house?
Yeah.
No? Well, reality check now. We're going to be staying all week, Catherine. How's that with you? Is that all right?
All right.
Lovely, jubbly. And this, of course, is the head of the family. This is Mom Diane. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Brilliant. A little bit early for you, this?
An awful lot early for me.
I've noticed you've got a nice cup of chai there. How about laying some on for us? Get kettle on then, Mum. Thanks very much. Later on, we're going to find out more about the family, get to know them a little bit better. But for right now, it's back to Rick and Sharron.
Thanks, Richard. That's brilliant. Richard, could you...
Yes, Rick.
Could you do something about their wallpaper while you're there for the whole week?
Yeah, sure, mate. Yeah.
Thanks, mate.
Lovely. It matches my skin tone,
though.
Oh,
bless.
Look at that.
That's not very nice.
Classic.
Beautiful stuff.
I think the mum's here, if you don't mind.
Thanks,
well, what does your book say?
I don't know. I just can't get into it. Okay. Here we are in our lovely library, and hopefully, you can be a library type person.
I'll be a librarian, shall I?
Yeah, that'd be nice.
I'm a librarian.
A sexy librarian at that. Well, on the way on the show, we've got Carl. Can I say sexy?
Yes.
Oh, you have now.
Carl Crompton's on the way. Andie Macdowell will be here, superstar.
Yay!
And also, Noel Gallagher will be on Snap.
But with the time at 7:18, it's a reason to be cheerful.
Oh.
And what did you do?
I sminted myself.
In public?
I know, I'm late, and I haven't even done my hair yet.
Head and Shoulders is pH balanced, and it's mild enough to use every day.
Now, I'm really late.
Walker's new barbecue-flavoured crisps are so irresistible, the world can suddenly seem a daunting place. Walker's barbecue crisps. Just make sure they're in safekeeping.
Name Postman Pats.
Cat.
Never seen it.
Even for a Dairy Lee slice.
Yes.
Kids will do anything for a Dairy Lee slice.
The title of the speech is, Are We Getting Our Just Desserts? Ready?
Yes, sir.
Are you sure you can handle the speech? You seem to be losing your powers of concentration.
Yes, just not sleeping too well, sir. I don't think I'm losing my powers of what did you say?
Concentration.
Yes, and that reason to be cheerful was Ooh, Miss Jones from the very best of Leonard Rosta. It's out today on video, which is good stuff. There's my Francis de la Tour impression. Oh, Mr. Ringsby, which is very good. Now, with the time at 7:20, it's time for us to find out what's going on in the Big Breakfast News headlines. Pete.
Rick, this is what's going on. Michael Howard's making headlines again today. There's a big rumpus over his decision to let two drug lords out of prison early. Alan Shearer continues to prove he's worth the $15 million Newcastle paid for him after doing the business last night in an England shirt. And we'll tell you why the lights are going out in Las Vegas. All that and more on the half hour. But for now, it's back to the house.
Thank you very much, Peter.
Oh, Sharon,
now, it's time for us to have that tour that I promised you. This is our den. How fabulous it is, too. Sunk into the floor. And this is where we spend an awful lot of our time. Now, the work that's been done on this house over the last 5 weeks has been absolutely incredible. I know the guys have been working 24 hours a day, so let's go see what they've done. Follow me. Our library, where we were just a few minutes ago, full of books, very, very important as well. What we have behind here... Oh, gosh, I'm supposed to be strong as well. I can't open the door! Right, oh, hang on! Oh, you fixed it on purpose. Oh, look. Thank you very much for that, ladies and gentlemen. This is our telephone room. They're working very, very hard in here.
Hello.
Part of my workout every day, isn't it, just to be pulling this around. So I think we need some grease on this, boys, please. And follow me on up the corridors. This table, by the way, is just worth mentioning. Look at the legs. For any children watching, don't. This is Babe, I think, here, really. A little pork chop. On upstairs, this is the boudoir, Vanessa's bedroom. As you can see, we've got rid of the bed. We no longer have a bed. We have a chaise. In fact, we have two chaise longues. Very, very posh. The walls have been marbled. Looks wonderful. And we've got some delightful nail varnish here. All sorts of things that belong to Vanessa. Carry on through. Coming to our galleried landing. As you can see, we started the programme here. Look down into the den. This is the front of the house. With our beautiful new landscaped gardens. Awful lot of work have gone into that. And we also have a lovely area for bands and barbecues and goodness knows what down the end. Fruit juice as well. I think we're going to get Rick making an apple pie later on. Carry on through. And this is a very special room. This is where the boys are. I'm looking forward to this. Hi, boys.
Yeah, no, but not on the first day.
Oh, hi.
Oh, hi, Sharron. Welcome to our room.
Thank you very much. It's a... Great to see you.
Yes, thank you.
Are you looking after our boy here?
Yes, yeah. We are indeed.
Okay.
I'm in really good hands.
Sharron, you're a new mum, you know that.
You creep.
Carry on down the stairs.
See ya.
This is kind of a... Bye-bye. This is kind of the TV area.
Bye.
Skippy, Star Trek, goodness knows. And this is the kitchen, where we do all our cooking and preparing our lunch and our dinner. Haven't got a cappuccino machine here yet, but hopefully we will have soon. Now, let's try and find the architect, the very important man that's been responsible for putting all of the hard work into this. Michael Merovitz, welcome.
Thank you. Still finishing off
some cleaning, are you?
Yeah.
Tell us about the house, because an awful lot of hard work has gone into it. You've hardly had any sleep, have you, for the last 5 weeks?
It's been exhausting, but everyone really put a huge effort in. It's been incredible, and the results are amazing. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. So, when did the guys finish?
About an hour before the show, actually.
Yeah, there has been some reports that these are fake walls. They're not, are they?
It's a very real building. It's a very real building, and it was done in as you said earlier, just over 5 weeks.
What was the style of the house?
Well, the main, main inspiration really is Lido, which is very
sort of
playful.
1930s,
yeah, well, you know, uses water, light. All the elements are very important, and people sort of, you know, enjoy fun in architecture, really, fun in buildings.
Yes, well.
And well, I think,
this is one of my favourite areas.
This is
a swimming pool. What more could I ask for?
Absolutely.
And a spa as well. We were going to sit and relax before and after the programme, so I don't know about relaxation.
Amazing.
And this is brilliant as well, isn't it? The big breakfast.
Yeah, absolutely. Carved in that huge wall over there. Very, very fitting. The whole area at the back here is to do with water, which is why the spa and the pool is here. It's got a rubberised floor.
Well done, Mike. You've done a brilliant job. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well done. This is Channel 4. You're watching The Big Breakfast. And if you'd like to write to us for any reason whatsoever, this is the address. The Big Breakfast. Lockkeepers Cottages. Old Ford Lock, London, E3 2NN. They're quicker than me.
The Crunch.
Yes! 7:25, Mrs.
Denise in there. It's Monday. It's
look at my chopper.
It's Zig. It's Zag. Yeah. I'm not Brian Adams or Rick Astley.
No,
I'm actually Rick Adams.
Sure? Okay, Rick Adams. Rick Adams. Got it. Okay, Adam. It's not just any old Monday. It's Magic Monday.
Yes. It's a Magic Monday.
Just another Magic Monday.
Warming up those vocal cords. But before we start our real magic, I thought I'd actually try a bit of a magic trick myself.
For you?
So yes, me. Got a problem with that.
He's new.
All right. Alien.
Go on then.
So let's bring in Casanova Chris. Casanova Chris, come
in
here.
Hi guys. Hi. It's good to see you. Morning.
Hi guys. You're a real hit with the ladies, aren't you?
Yeah, well, there's Catherine, there's Kitty.
Is that where you're wearing Raging Stud aftershave?
Yeah.
Okay, now listen. How tall are you, Chris?
6'2", Rick.
Okay, well, how about this, boys? I'm going to make all 6'2" of Casanova Chris disappear.
Go on.
Are you ready? Here we go. Okay, Chris. There's a girl downstairs in a bikini top and it's just come off. Could you go and help her back into it?
Yes!
Absolutely fantastic.
Wow. Where's
he gone? Of course he has, mate. He's gone, wouldn't you? Okay, so there we are. But let's get on to some real magic now.
Let's indeed.
Shall we introduce him?
We certainly will.
We have our very own, very young magician. It's Chris Cox from Bristol coming in.
Chris!
Chris!
Okay,
Chris,
how's
Chris?
What's your name and where do you come from then?
Chris, and I come from Bristol.
Okay, Chris. We're going to see if your trick is magic or tragic.
That's it.
We're judging it.
So would you like to show it?
I'll get it off you.
Okay, what a magician. Here we go. We've got all the patterns.
Okay, get it
here.
Can you hold that, please?
I can hold that. Yeah, I think so.
People have told me how foreign coins are funny. Here we have 3 French francs. We put this piece of paper over the 3 French francs. Thank you.
There we go.
And then we shove it. Here we have 3 pencils.
No.
3 ordinary pencils on a normal case.
Right, okay.
Yeah, normal case, just bang things in there. Whatever you want to do, you can do it.
Whatever you do with pencils, yes.
Okay, but now we're going to show the magic bit.
No.
Ooh. Ready? Yeah.
Okay, we're ready.
Oh,
yeah.
Mummy!
What?
No way! No!
And the
cruelty to coins!
Yes!
That's real for those coins. That is very impressive, isn't it?
So what do you think of that?
I think it's magic. I reckon he's got 6 pencils.
So you're going to show us how you do it, then?
If you want to.
Yeah, go on.
All right.
It's not the magic circle.
Here we have 3
close
coins.
Close for 12, shall we?
Here we go. There's a little thing here.
Yeah.
Just push that in.
Yeah.
And out slide the coin.
No way!
Put it through. And when you put it back...
And that's as simple as that.
Simple as that.
Shall we try that with Sharron later on?
Yeah, let's try that with Sharron.
Stick up one of those boxy things.
Yeah. Listen, if you want to come on Magic Monday, this is the address you write to. It's magic. The Big Breakfast, Lockkeepers Cottages, Old Ford Lock, London E32NN.
But now, stand by for another magic reason to be cheerful.
Winston East back in the house.
My name is Elaine Latham. I'm the artist that created Magic Dip
just for you, and it will make you an artist, too. I'm going to work with maybe three or four colors. I haven't made up my mind, and I guess that's the artist in me. So I am going to make a really nice design now. You're going to have so much fun. You are going to be going round and round, say, what do I dip? What do I dip? You're going to get dipping fever. What a pair of sneakers. Here's a pussycat. Oh, well, this is more fun than anything you've ever done before in your life.
She kept saying, man, how am I gonna run this way right now? Tango. It's always the same, man. And I said, man, I'm gonna run this way like that forever.
I'm a god. I'm not the god. I don't think.
Because you survived a car wreck?
You folks ready to order?
I didn't just survive a wreck. I wasn't just blown up yesterday. I have been stabbed, shot, poisoned, frozen, hung, electrocuted, and burned.
Oh, really?
And every morning I wake up without a scratch on me, not a dent in the fender. I am an immortal.
Special today is blueberry waffles.
Oh, Sharron.
Oh,
Sharron,
Rick,
don't forget about Derek. Forget about...
Oh, sorry. Right, of course, that was a brilliant clip there. It was from Groundhog Day.
Really?
It was starring the beautiful... Well, she's beautiful too, but Andie Macdowell will be with us here later on.
Yay!
Live and in the flesh. Of course, also we've got millionaire lottery winner Carl Crompton popping in with his money sacks. And also we'll have our up-to-the-minute travel and weather from our dolly trolley in the sky.
On the menu in the next 20 minutes. At 7.40, we rejoin Richard, who is staying with one lucky family all week. At 7.45, Noel Gallagher reveals all with Joe Wiley at Snap, Cackle and Pop. At 7.50, the top five for the first time on TV this week. But at 7.31, it's over to Richard. To Richard.
No, it's Peter.
Sorry, Peter. Sorry, Peter, for the news.
You're forgiven. Good morning. These are the main stories on Monday, the 2nd of September. Michael Howard's under fire over the early release of two heroin dealers. Skipper on the score sheet, Alan Shearer seals victory for England. And the original bright lights of Las Vegas shine again. Two men are beginning a holiday, having been freed after 12 months of an 18-year jail sentence for heroin dealing. The Home Secretary Michael Howard has been deluged with complaints over his decision to release John Hass and Paul Bennett. It was based on the trial judge pointing out that the men had shot other dealers. The parents of a loyalist hardliner have been the victims of a hand grenade attack on their home. Alex Kerr has received death threats along with Billy Wright because of fears they want to break the ceasefire. Kerr's parents escaped serious injury. Police are unable to say if the body of a boy found on a Norfolk beach is that of 4-year-old Tom Loughlin. He vanished 2 weeks ago from a beach nearby with his sister Jodie. She was found drowned on Friday. There'll be more postal delays today. Unions are holding an 8th 24-hour stoppage following Friday's strike. The Royal Mail has angrily attacked the union for deciding not to ballot its members on a new pay and conditions offer. Kim Wilde is waking up to a new life as Mrs. Fowler. The 35-year-old married Tommy co-star Hal Fowler in Hertfordshire yesterday. The couple are honeymooning somewhere in Britain. They say they're keen to start a family, but better be quick because they're back on stage on Friday. A victorious England team arrived home from Moldova in the early hours, having notched up a 3-0 opener in the World Cup qualifiers. With a new coach and captain at the helm, Glenn Hoddle and Alan Shearer can be pleased with the scoreline. Shearer got the third goal, but Hoddle says he knows they can do much better. There was a spectacular start to the Round the World Yacht Race. 14 identical vessels sailed along the Thames past some of London's most famous landmarks. They were heading for Southampton to start their 10-month voyage, which will cover 30,000 miles. 20 years ago, they symbolized Las Vegas' reputation for high risk and big bucks. Now the city's original neon signs are lying in a junkyard. The pensioned-off bright lights are, however, being restored and will soon appear in the Nevada Museum of Neon Art. It's 7.33. We're back at 8. Here's Rick and Sharron.
Thank you, Peter. It's apparent to me that people want to find their natural tone colours with their shirts, and Peter's found it. It's blue. He's a blue boy. Look at that. Nice eyes. There we are. Very important, very important. Always put that in wardrobe. Okay.
Thank you very much, Peter.
Thank you, Peter. Sorry. It was a bit touch and go this morning because we had a bit of a low cloud base, whatever that means. But apparently, we tried to go to Telecom and we couldn't get to it, but we can do it now. We did it earlier. And what we're going to do now is go up to something that's huge. It has big rotors. Yes, it's time to go to our eye in the sky, underneath, for our big breakfast telecopter.
Denise Van Outen, where are you?
Good morning, I'm in Newcastle. You're right there, we did have a few problems this morning, but our good old pilot, Nigel, got it sorted. Say hello, Nigel. Handsome chap. Now, the weather here in Newcastle at the moment seems to be clearing. As you can see, we're just hovering over the Tyne, and it's all mine. And the clouds seem to be moving on. There was very heavy rain earlier this morning, but it seems to be getting better as the morning goes on. Now, in the rest of the country, the temperatures are looking like this. There will be an average of 20 degrees, ranging from 80 degrees in Glasgow and Belfast to 22 degrees in Plymouth. And as for chances of rain, in Glasgow, there will be a 60% chance of getting wet, so get your Wellington boots out. And in Cardiff and Plymouth, it will remain dry. And the outlook, well, it's another mixed bag. In northwest Scotland, it's going to be cloudy with drizzle. In the east, it's going to be cloudy also. In southwest England and South Wales, you should have a very nice day, quite warm with some sunshine. In North Wales, Northern Ireland and Southern England, it's going to be dry and warm with cloud. Now the traffic, we're just hovering over the A1 at the moment and it's starting to become slightly congested. It has been moving very well all morning, but obviously we're going to hit rush hour soon, so be prepared for that. Now the A40 in London is actually now open. It was closed earlier due to a burst water main, but that is now open so you can go there. The M4 is very heavy southbound. That's heading towards the airport, so avoid if possible. Surprise, surprise, the M25 junctions 23 to 23 has delays and this is due to an accident. On the M1, junction 16 to 17, there is a lorry on fire, so there's very, very heavy delays. Lots of congestion there, so make sure you avoid that. Well, that's it from me, Denise Van Outen and about in the Big Breakfast helicopter. I'll catch you later.
Thank you so much,
Denise. We said that in unison.
Absolutely. We both meant it, too, which has been rather wonderful. Let's take a look now at our newspapers. It's a good thing to do. And there's some interesting stories, so
I'll start off with the obvious one, because we've got Kim Wilde. We mentioned her on the news. Peter mentioned her on the news.
Yeah.
And there's a lovely picture of her here.
Aww. She's looking very slim and
she's a big
lovely.
Favourite, isn't she, on the
yeah.
Big Breakfast?
Yeah.
Yes, she is. She's absolutely gorgeous.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
So well done to Kim. Now, there's a story in The Sun today. And it says, 2 million telly set is a big dog's breakfast. Oh, boy, are they feeling bad this morning? Because we've got it all together. In fact, they were going through all these things and saying, we've got lots of problems. And it says, a TV insider here said, it's absolute chaos. Well, if they were rehearsing yesterday, they probably are right. But today, it seems a bit more sedate and relaxed. And everything's together, isn't it?
Are you sure?
OK, so there we are. That's The Sun.
Now, we've got a little piece here in The Telegraph, which says about lottery millionaires. And actually, as we have a lottery millionaire on the programme, I thought we'd mention it.
Millionaire.
Half of the people who have won lottery jackpots have preferred to return to work rather than indulge in a life of leisure, Camelot said yesterday.
Absolutely, I'd rather work.
51% of winners have resisted the temptation to sit back and count their winnings and have decided to continue their careers. We can talk to Carl about that, can't we? I don't think he's working, is he?
And, of course, big tip as well is that 44 has turned up at the National Lottery for the last 5 weeks. Mm-hmm. So make sure you do that. My dad got three and got very excited, and I think he just won £10, so that was about it, really. So hard luck. But papers-wise, that's about it. Also, I saw today that apparently the £50 note is going out soon. So you must make sure it's going out of legal tender very soon.
The £20 note will be the biggest one?
Well, I just thought that maybe what we could do is if you've got any of your £50 notes, you want to send them in to me and I'll make sure you get £20 for them. Okay, so we'll sort that out that way.
Very, very good.
Shall we take a look at our phone in this morning?
Yeah.
And it goes like this. The question of the day goes a bit like this. Now, we want you to give us that warm feeling, apart from the fact I've had that already in my dressing room. There have been lots and lots of technical problems, maybe, that have dogged you in your life. You know, maybe you had an electronic tin opener that went a bit barmy.
Gizmos.
So why don't you tell us about the times that technical problems have happened?
Gizmos and gadgets. Now, we've got a couple of faxes here.
OK, quickly. We've got Andrew Singleton in Preston. I put a fresh fuse into my eye and it exploded, ruining my best jeans.
Jonathan from Leicester said here, food blender was blending carrots and broke down, so it was lumpy, not smooth.
OK.
As long as he didn't put his finger in there, that's what made it lumpy.
I love the word lumpy. If you'd like to get involved, then the phone numbers go as follows. It's... let's have a look at where they are now.
Very clever.
A nice bottom there. It's
0181 985 1111.
And fax as well, 985-2222. A little bit of a mantra there. We're all joining in. Now, coming up, of course, we've got Noel Gallagher in Snap, Cackle and Pop. And also lottery millionaire Carl Crompton will be popping in with his money and hopefully giving us a receipt. But there you go. But now it's time to stand by for a reason to be cheerful. Cheerful was, of course, a clip from that slick American soap with that slick American comedian. His name is Jerry Seinfeld, and you can see that on BBC Two tonight, which is always very exciting. Now, we were having a few technical problems earlier on, actually. We were saying that our phone-in was, of course, yes, what the question of the day is, technical problems. We were going to go to Richard on the outside broadcast, that's OB, if you want to be technical, unfortunately, we couldn't do, but now we can.
Yes, Richard surprised a family this morning. He's going to be with them all week, so let's find out. Who's the family, Richard?
Thank you very much, Sharron and Rick. Yeah, don't worry, I put 50p in the meter. Oh, blimey, that's very tick. That's good, that, isn't it? Look at that. A bit of a banana there for Mom Diana. The way. There's the Turners, is the family. The Turners from Yorkshire in Cleckheaton. Hooray! Hooray, and look, very cosy, Mom Diane. You've already set us up some cornflakes. We've got coffee. Are you going to pamper me all week?
Oh, definitely.
Oh, she's a lovely woman. She's a lovely woman. I love her already. So, OK, let's introduce everyone to the nation, as it were. So who we got over here, then? Wendy?
I am Wendy, and I'm 16.
She's 16, and you go to school?
I start sixth form on Wednesday.
Sixth form on Wednesday. Now, someone is going to be starting school today, in fact. It's Catherine. Hello, Catherine, how are you?
Fine.
You banged yourself on a shelf earlier, is that right?
Yeah.
Look at that. Can we see that? Turn around, have a look. Oh! Yeah. How did you do that? She always doing stuff like that.
Oh, yeah.
A little bit dizzy, yeah?
Quite
yeah,
not.
Never mind. Okay, maybe she knocked some sense into her. Now, over here we've got Phil. He's the son of the family. Ooh, hang on. Steady. Trouble in the ranks. Why did you boo him?
Well, he's a boy.
He's a boy.
We only keep him because we have
I to. See. So that's the way of it, is it? I'll just go over here then and side with Phil. How are you, Phil? You all right, mate?
Yeah.
Do you go to school?
Yeah.
What school is it?
Wycliffe Mount.
Oh, I see. Right, so who's got the most annoying habit in the family? Dish the dirt, mate. Have a think about it. Look at it. Who would you say? What about Mum snoring? Let's hear about Mum snoring. Apparently you've got a really loud snore, Mum. Is this true?
I don't believe a word of it.
Who says that? Catherine, yeah?
I think it's Tom.
Can you hear it from your room? You want to do something about that? What about the kids? Have they got a bad habit you want to talk about?
Well, she tells lies.
Does she? Oh, what, I mean, like banging into shelves and stuff, for example.
Never snored in my life.
Right. Oh, there's a fight already. Good, that's first day fight. Lovely. Now, who's a good singer here? Because apparently... well, I've heard it was all of you. Is this true?
Should we get a... can't sing to save a life.
Well, let's find out, shall we? Bit of a group laugh. No, okay, after three. One, two, three. La. Yeah, you're right. Phil can't sing. You cannot sing.
I can.
Fantastic. Well, where did you come off thinking you can sing then? Where's all this come from? Choir?
Natural.
So fancy yourself as a bit of a pop star then, Phil?
Yeah.
He's got the cap, actually. I mean, look, if you spin it around, he's 17. It's there. It's in the bag. So, Catherine, going back to you, you're going to school today, aren't you? It's your first day at a new school. You're nervous?
Yeah.
Excited?
Yeah.
Is this your school uniform that you've got on now? What happened to the old ties then? No ties anymore. Oh, no, it's there. Oh, I see. Well, she doesn't dress very well, does she, Mum? You want to sort that out. You got her a packed lunch?
No, she stays to school for lunch.
Oh, she stays to school. Can you get me a packed lunch? Is that all right? Because I've got to go out later.
Yeah, that's no problem.
Fantastic. All right, lovely. Right, we've got our cornflakes. Thank you very much. And by the way, I like your wallpaper.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you very much. Oh, I made a right old hash of this. Right then, later on, we'll be talking to the family and we'll be going around the house. Can you give me a guided tour?
No problem.
Lovely.
No,
she's such a lovely woman and we've got a lovely family here. Very excited indeed. It's back over to Rick and Sharron now.
Bye.
See you later.
Thank you, boy. Now, I think if Phil's a proper rock star, you should get him to actually walk out in Liam Gallagher style. Go on, get him to walk out.
Yeah, okay.
Can I have a stroll?
Liam Gallagher impression, Phil, yeah? Off you go. Liam Gallagher, walk out.
No
Liam
finger
Gallagher.
Signs, please.
Right, up you get. I'll show you it's done. Hang on a sec, don't worry. I'm on the ball. Here we go. Right, it's a bit like this, mate, all right? It's a bit like... go.
That's it, you got it. That's it. Respect to you, Richard.
There we go.
Thanks
How's
for that. We'll see you later, mate. Cheers.
Thank you very much. Now, Joe Wiley presents Snap, Cackle and Pop with an exclusive interview with Noel Gallagher.
Snap. Cackle. Pop.
Hi, I'm Joe Wiley and you're watching Music News on Snap, Cackle and Pop. Just when you thought you'd heard it all from Oasis, the bad boys of rock have shocked again. After last week's Departure Lounge fiasco, the boys are now 7 days into their 14-date tour of the States. But in his last British television interview, Noel spoke exclusively to Snap, Cackle and Pop backstage at Nebworth. The press, the pressure of fame, the future of the greatest rock and roll band in the world, and that fastest selling gig in history are all given the Gallagher treatment.
And it's history in the making, you know. Well, someone's going to meet the future wife of it tonight. People say that we don't say enough in our music, but I mean, what is there to say, really? Because maybe. We just want to make people have a good time, forget what's on the news and forget Bosnia and all the rest of it. I'm blessed with a lot of nervous energy, you know what I mean? I'll sleep for 2 hours and I'll just wake up and I'll get up and I'll be on the phone and I'll start doing things because that's what I do, you know, that's what I do, I like doing it. A lot of Morning Glory was written on the road. Looking back on it now, it sounds like it was. You know, the songs like Hey Now and Cast No Shadow and Don't Look Back in Anger are all sort of... I wouldn't say they were, you know, down songs, but they're not as jolly as the stuff on the first album. It's like, you know, Nevermind the and like Revolver and the White Album and Exile on Main Street and all these great albums, you know, like that signpost in history. I mean, now I'm beginning to believe that Morning Glory's up there with them. There's a price to pay when you're famous. You've got to remember our first single was number 31 in the charts. Ever since, it's not been a slow build, we just exploded like that.
Here they are, kids. They're great. Please welcome Oasis.
We have a good, pretty relationship with the tabloid press.
Liam, can we come in and talk to you?
Halfway from the door.
Can we come in and have a quick...
Come in. What do you think? You daft?
We say to these cameramen, look, right? I'm going to stand here for 2 minutes now, right? Take a photograph and then will you please leave me alone? Slip inside the eye of your mind. Don't you know you might find... The real time where we'll have to come off and do other things and then reconvene at certain points to carry on Oasis. You said that you'd never be. Saying that, I don't know, you know what I mean? I've got no plans to do anything. I'm not writing with anyone else. I'm not I'm not planning on going solo. No one's planning on leaving the group. There's definitely going to be a next record, and I plan on starting the one after that quite soon, because I've written about another six or seven songs. So. I think the Stones are playing Wembley on 1999. They booked Wembley, haven't they, for 1999? But I can safely say to Mick and Keith that no one's going to turn up, because we're playing in 1999 as well. maybe they can support us.
That's today's story, but tomorrow never knows, which is why we all love Oasis, never a dull moment. Next week, Noel talks about his future as a film star.
It's an excellent part.
His bank balance.
I don't even want to know how much money I've made.
And his obituary.
Like, myself personally, to be remembered as someone who just wrote good songs and had a laugh while he was doing it.
I'm Jo Wiley for Snap, Cackle and Pop.
Jo Wiley there on Snap. And maybe next week we'll get Noel to send apart his eyebrows.
Well, apparently there's a lot of controversy in America, isn't there? Because Liam's only just gone after doing a bit of house hunting.
Prima donna.
He's found his little place. And
he's allowed to. Yeah. He's allowed to have his little wee bingo and little tantrums. Why not? I would. We do in the mornings. This makeup is the right colour! So, of course, Noel Gallagher, 40 million a year he earns, apparently.
That's it.
A lot of money, yeah. So there you go.
Nearly as much as you, right?
Absolutely. Well, 41. So there we are. But now it's time for us to take a look, because we are the first TV show here in the UK to take a look at the top five hits in the charts. So let's take a look at it now.
The official CIN music chart. Five.
Please see the Charlatans are back.
Yeah.
And number three. So that's pretty darn good, in my view. And also the Spice Girls, of course. That video is shot in one take. That's it. No cuts, no nothing.
You keep going out and buying new records, don't you, every week? Because you like those girls. You're sitting with your tongue
I know, it's just very embarrassing. That's all I seem to do this morning. I do apologise for that. So anyway.
Well, with the time at 7.52, let's go over to Peter Smith to find out what's in the news.
Well, wherever Michael Howard goes these days, controversy seems to follow. His decision to let two drug barons out of prison early is causing a fuss that could run for a while. England start their World Cup campaign with a winner, but Hoddle thinks they can do better. And we have explicit pictures from a stag party in Denmark. All that and more on the hour, but for now it's back to the house.
Cheers for that, Peter. Exclusive stuff. Cheers, mate. See you later.
Thank you.
Now, of course, our question of the day.
Technos.
How'd you do that, Sharron?
That would be a secret.
Okay, so the question of the day is, of course, we've got lots of new gizmos here. Icky the cameraman. It's not new, you're an old bloke, aren't you?
And a lot of old gizmos as well.
And we're trying to get them up to speed and work and find the right batteries and things, and it was all working so far. Worst thing to say on live television. So we want to know about the times when things have gone slightly pear-shaped, really.
Mm.
And we're taking your calls, your faxes as well. So let's take a look at some of them.
I've got one here from Ben Hudson from Exeter. He says his two-year-old microwave has started to blow up anything that he cooks. The door springs open and the food is sprayed around the kitchen.
That's fantastic. That's a boy's own thing, isn't it? It's like, yeah, exploding Vestas.
I hope he's a good cleaner-upper.
No, absolutely. And I'm Irene Baker from High Wycombe. A washing machine that starts dancing. We're going to do the macaroni later, so we can teach you to do that. But apparently when it reaches its spin cycle, it starts jumping up and down. And she says she often sits on it. No, it's often in a cubbyhole. That's what it is. Right.
I have a really bad joke for you.
What's that?
What do you call a nun sitting on a washing machine?
I don't know.
Systematic.
That was
it's
bad.
It's a washing machine joke, isn't it?
It's
funny.
It's, Okay, we've got Rosie from Littlehampton, and her tape recorder playing. Her tape recorder apparently is human because it's very choosy about the tapes which I play. If I play Oasis, that's fine. Yeah, okay. But if I try to play my Pet Shop Boys tape, well, what do you expect? I mean, for goodness sake, it chews them up. So, do you think it's trying to tell me something? Well, the question is, do you think it's trying to tell you something, Rosie?
Still to come up in the show, we have Hollywood superstar Andie Macdowell live in the house. But with time now at 7:54, you're watching The Big Breakfast on Channel 4. And this is the address that you need to write to if you want to send us anything. It is...
Oh, it's a big dumper truck! Hey!
The Big Breakfast!
Lawkeeper's cottages! Home for luck! London E3!
If you're not registered to vote, you can't have a say. Your council will send you a form.
Why not part exchange your old house for a stunning new Barrett home? For details, call Barrett on 0345 6263 64.
What's the nuttiest thing you've ever done?
Walking on the beach. Someone's false teeth. I put them in my bucket and I went here and the lady went.
Nope! New nuttiest sun hat!
Yes.
It's the nuttiest thing you've ever done!
Shampoo specially designed for men. Brill cream was good enough for his granddad. And Jack's just as sensible.
The hair and scalp with protein. That should keep him fit. And with the healthy looking mop of hair, he might even start courting.
New Brill Cream Shampoo, made for men.
And in a living room tonight, a woman in a blue cardigan cemented her husband on the sofa. This practice is becoming...
Do you worry about tough stains? Course not. You add new Vanish Inwash to your detergent. Brilliant.
Are you in the know about Cheerios?
No, I like them.
What about nutrition?
Nutrition.
Corn, oats, rice and wheat. For green nutrition and not too sweet.
What, in one cereal?
Given only in Cheerios.
You know that.
I know that.
Are you in the know about Cheerios?
Want to take them home? Soon you can. Give a home to 101 Dalmatians, yours to own on video from September the 4th.
Big breakfast as we see our fantastic new house and a little bit of, can we show this bit of topiary down here, Jo?
Very nice. Did you do this? Did you not get up this morning?
With my electric razor. It's like, oh, I've got something else to do. Anyway, my name is Rick Adams.
And I'm Sharron Davies still.
And this is a fantastic new house, a fantastic new show. Hope you're enjoying it. And I want to show you that we have finished this house, but Jo, maybe you'd just like to pan over there just quickly.
Yeah.
And we've still got some of the bricks
there. A few boxes and a few tiles.
So we're getting it sorted, but we'd like to take you inside. So come with us, if you will, for a magical mystery tour into our house. So I'll follow Sharron.
This is our gallery.
Okay, so here we are now in the gallery, which is very nice. And I'm going to... No, I'm not.
Oh, look at the meeting down there. Save us a piece.
Let's take a look, because we've got... Look at these showbiz people. Hi! Hello!
Hello!
Hello down there. Yeah. Andie Macdowell.
Hello! Is
Andie?
Nice Andie Macdowell's here.
Andie. Hi, Andie. Do you want my number? Oh.
I'm sorry.
Let the poor woman alone.
Andie, it's great to see you. How are you?
I'm very well, thanks.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I think so.
How's the British toast?
It's pretty.
A bit wobbly by the looks of it.
It's fantastic, isn't it? And of course, the lovely Vanessa.
Yeah, lovely I am.
Vanessa.
I've never looked lovelier than sitting next to Andie. This is my loveliest.
You look gorgeous.
You look completely tanned by Vanessa.
I'm so miserable. I'm eating the toast. That's my.
Vanessa, can I ask you, who are you more thrilled to sit next to?
I was hoping he might be in the show, actually, so I'm quite thrilled to see him.
I want to see him.
Carl, how are you? 10.9 million. Carl Crompton, our lottery winner. Now, Carl, yes. Can you just empty your pockets for us, mate? You got any dosh on you?
How much loose change is in there?
Yeah, have a look. Nothing in there at all?
Well, there is...
Come on, empty your pockets.
There's nothing in it. There's nothing in it.
Emptying his pockets.
Empty.
Look. There's nothing in there.
Lend us a tenner. If you can spend that so far. On the menu in the next 20 minutes. At 8:05, more up-to-date weather and travel from the brand new Big Breakfast helicopter. At 8:10, we will introduce you to our Big Breakfast pet and it talks. And at 8:20, an exclusive look at the diary of lottery millionaire Carl Crompton.
Thank you very much. Well, I'm assured that the time is now 8 o'clock exactly. So let's go over to Peter Smith for the Big Breakfast news.
Good morning. These are the main stories on Monday, the 2nd of September. The nation's anger as Howard sets two heroin drug lords free. England expects, and this time they didn't disappoint, and a stag party that's forced a steward's inquiry. The Home Secretary Michael Howard has defended his decision to allow the early release of two heroin dealers. John Haas and Paul Bennett had served only 12 months of their 18-year sentences. They were freed early because they gave evidence against other traffickers. There's been a hand grenade attack on the home of the parents of loyalist hardliner Alex Kerr. He's received death threats along with Billy Wright because of fears they plan to break the ceasefire. Mr. and Mrs. Kerr escaped serious injury. Police are trying to establish if the body of a boy found on a Norfolk beach is that of 4-year-old Tom Loughlin. He vanished with his 6-year-old sister Jodie from a beach near Hunstanton. Her body was found washed up nearby on Friday. Your letters will be delayed again. After last Friday's strike, postal workers are holding their 8th 24-hour stoppage today. The Royal Mail is angry that unions won't balance their members on a new pay and conditions offer. Iraq still controls the Kurdish safe haven it captured at the weekend. The country's defense minister says Saddam Hussein has told him to pull out their troops, but that hasn't yet happened. Bill Clinton has put American forces in the Gulf on red alert. Doctors in Calcutta treating Mother Teresa say she's now developed chest complications. She was being treated for malaria and heart problems, but x-rays have shown dark patches on her lungs. Kim Wilde is starting her first day as a married woman. The 35-year-old Tommy actress and co-star husband Hal Fowler are honeymooning at a secret location in Britain after tying the knot in Hertfordshire yesterday. She's already keen to swap showbiz for motherhood, but has to be back on stage on Friday. Alan Shearer led a victorious return home to Luton Airport this morning after a convincing start to England's World Cup campaign. It was 3-0 over Moldova with goals from Nick Barmby, Paul Gascoigne and new skipper Alan Shearer. British Formula One hero Damon Hill is already believed to be in talks with a number of rival teams after being dumped by Frank Williams and Renault for next season. Victory in Monza in 6 days' time will guarantee Hill the world championship. The big question is, why was he sacked? A stag party forced stewards to call off a race meeting in Denmark. Wild deer invaded the course at Copenhagen and were having none of it when spectators tried to clear them. The meeting was postponed for 24 hours. It's 8:02. We're back at 8:30. Here's Rick and Sharron.
Thank you very much, Peter.
My pleasure.
We've shared our first hour together, Peter.
We have. Isn't it fun?
It is. It's fun.
It's manic.
A man who's so old that he knew the Dead Sea when it was ill. So thank you very much. Cheers for that. They're old.
They get worse, don't they? And I thought my nun joke was bad.
They're old, they're cheesy, and I love it. Now I've got to tell you something extremely exciting. Thanks for that, Peter. Sorry about that. We have got a brand new service to tell you about. It's very exciting. It's very big, and it'll bring you the up-to-date traffic even, and weather. And we're going to go up into the sky for our eye in the sky. Yes, it's our big breakfast helicopter.
Ooh. Denise Van Outen, where are you?
Good morning. I'm just hovering over Newcastle. And earlier on, we actually spotted a Vulcan bomber, as you can see. But it's not as nice as my chopper, is it, Nigel? Oh, sorry, he's telling me off. Now, the weather here in Newcastle seems to be getting better and better as the morning goes on. It's actually clearing. The clouds seem to be drifting away over the coast. In the rest of the country, temperatures are looking like this. There is an average of 20 degrees, ranging from 18 degrees in Glasgow and Belfast to 22 degrees in Plymouth. Now, the chances of rain, in Glasgow, they have a 60% chance of rain, so get your Wellington boots and your brollies out. And in Cardiff, it's going to be a very dry day. The outlook, well, it's another mixed bag. In northwest Scotland, it will be cloudy with drizzle. In the east, it's going to be cloudy. And in southwest England and South Wales, you should have a nice dry day, quite warm with some sunshine. In North Wales, Northern Ireland and Southern England, it'll be dry and warm with cloud. And now I have a big breakfast, fascinating fact for you. Did you know that Newcastle has 15 bridges across the Tyne? But you didn't know that. Now the traffic. Now the A1 is actually, at the moment, looking like this. It seems to be moving quite well and moving quite smoothly. But in the rest of the country, the M6 at Junction 10, the traffic is stationary. It's not moving at all southbound. And on northbound, it's actually quite heavy between junctions 4A and 5. And the M1, as I mentioned earlier, there was a lorry on fire. This is causing serious delays at the junctions between 16 and 17. And the M25, yep, you guessed it, between junctions 23 and 22, there are heavy delays due to an earlier accident. Well, that's it from me, Denise Van Outen about. It's back to Rick and Sharron.
Thank you very much indeed for that, Denise. What? Fine. You all right?
What do you think?
Yes. He's got more money than sense, this bloke. Anyway, Denise, thank you very much for that. And I've been having a look at the weekend over the... looking at... I'm sorry to...
Do you look at the Guardian? Do you honestly look at the Guardian?
Standing in front of a megastar. I look at the Guardian on Mondays as well. I've got a new job. We're looking here. And, of course, Bill Clinton's new campaign centres around a very exciting new dance. It's called the Macarena. No, it's not the Macaroni. All right, now that's that.
Macaroon.
It's actually come out on video so that we can teach you how to do it. Will Veloz, or is it Will Floss? I don't know. He wears a very exciting shirt, but there's a slash to the waist here, which is a V-neck, his hair cascading over the front.
Oh, cool.
He's going to
a big medallion.
Absolutely, I think I should have one of those. He's going to be teaching us how to do the dance. So let's learn how to do it. Are you ready, crew?
Yes!
Are you ready, Andy? You won't need any help. You'll just stand there and look cool.
As ready as we'll ever be,
so,
I think.
First of all, let's go over to Will. And Will, what's your first tip?
So the first thing you want to do is spread your feet apart, shoulder width, approximately. Now, you want a slight bend of the knees, slightly, and you want to get this motion, like a sway, like shifting, a shift of the weight in the hip.
Oh, we like this.
So there we are. We seem to have got that one right. Thanks, okay.
We like
got
this one. No
okay.
problem, no
Andy,
sweat.
You need a bit of hand. Hang on, let me see. Okay. That's fine. Just move it around like that. That's fantastic. Okay, oh, more than Andy. Yeah, okay, so let's just pack it in. I'm allowed. That's why I do this job. Let's take a look at tip number two from Will.
So the next thing we're going to do is the arm movements in the Macarena. So you extend your right arm first out, then the left arm, then the right arm goes to the back of your head on the neck area, and the left, then it goes down to the hip on the side, and then the left.
Okay. So it looks fairly simple, doesn't it? So we've got that fast, we just go through it very quickly.
Yes.
So shoulder width, here we go, let's rotate those hips. Okay, and now let's do the hands. Hands on the head, here we go.
That's
really embarrassing. Hey. Right. And that's it. Thank you very much. Okay.
And then that is.
And let's go. No, there's another tip, I'm afraid. Oh. So let's take a look. Will, here's another tip.
Now that we've got that, let's go through the weight of the legs again. Right, left, right, left. Now extend your right arm out, left arm out, back, back. Hip, hip, We've got that.
Yeah, we got that one. And we're feeling good this morning.
Yes!
To do that. Okay, fine. So let's get on with it now. Let's take it from the top. Are you ready to do that?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
All right. Here we go. Frank Hammer better teach than old Will, but let's take it away. Here we go.
Woo!
Ready? Okay. So let's swing those hips. Okay. Now hands in front.
Hey, Macarena.
And, okay, I think we've done it.
Let's do that again.
Okay. Yeah.
Hey, Macarena.
Ha! And of course, what you can do at home if you want to practice this, put a tea cozy on your head. Just looks stupid, really, but just do it. And you can move around each side.
Hey,
so that's the idea.
Macarena.
So there we go. Look at that. Andie Macdowell does the Macarena.
Woo!
But now, it's time for something completely different.
Beginning of the day starts quite early, and I want to be out on the road with the dogs, which is quite a lot of them, you know, for 6:30, 6:45, because the dogs need 3/4 of an hour's exercise, and I need 3/4 of an hour's exercise.
We have got 2 children. I do a little bit of office work, and it's mainly answering telephones. And then weekends we open a tea shop, so I run that.
Well, it's all perfect, you know. We love every single day. Comes along, you know, wake up with a big smile, glad to be alive.
There are lots of lovely birds on this show, and this is one of them. This is a minor bird, and what we're doing here at the Big Breakfast is we thought, well, we've got our own pet on the chopper, but we thought we'd have our pet down on the ground here. This is a minor bird, and we're going to be looking after our pet in a responsible manner. Will you stop freaking out and having a prima donna strop? Thank you. Right, now, Rob is our specialist here and knows all about minor birds, so welcome, uh-huh. Rob, to the Big Breakfast. I'll shake your hands in a showbiz way. Whoop. So tell us a bit about this crazy, groovy minor bird.
This is a hill minor, which is from India and Southeast Asia. Mm. Now, this one is a youngster that's been hand-reared, and it's about 4 months old.
4 months. So what sort of things do they eat?
Well, mainly fruit. They have a special mixture for minor birds, and insects as well, I'm afraid.
Yeah, there's some wriggly things in here. What kind of insects?
These are mealworms.
Really? And are they alive?
They are, I'm afraid.
Would you like to show the look, can we just have a look at this? Look, there's mealworms. That'll go nicely with your cornflakes, won't it? That'll be very nice. So there we are. We've done the eating and stuff, but how much do they cost? Are they very expensive?
They are anywhere between £100 and £200, I'm afraid.
What? We could have got a hamster and spent some money on this, on the house or something. But no, this minor bird is classy. And the reason the minor bird is classy is because what does it do that's extremely special, Rob?
Well, they talk.
Yeah?
Yes, hopefully.
They talk. Now, is it right to say that only 70% of them can talk? I mean, that's a lot.
Yeah,
anyway,
you can't guarantee everyone's going to talk. A lot of them will say several hundred words, but normally about 20 words if you're lucky.
So how exactly do they talk?
Well, they talk very much like ourselves, but to teach them, it's by repetition. So you've either got to sit there all night saying hello, or an easy way of doing it is to put them next to the telephone.
Can I try that now?
You can.
Okay. Now, I just must explain that we haven't actually got around to sexing our minor bird yet, because you can't tell for a couple of months, can you, with minor birds?
No, we have to get them.
So we'll be having a good old look in a couple of weeks to see whether it's a boy or a girl. If it's a boy, we're going to call it Alan. If it's a girl, we're going to call it Julie. Inspired names, I think. So now let's have a chat with it. So, hello, Alan, Julie. A bit confused. Well, obviously, this bird isn't... No, it's not going to say anything because he's an East End bird and he'll only talk when he's got a lawyer present. So that's the reason. So what we're going to do is we want to look after this bird very well, Rob. I mean, are there any tips that we need to know just to make sure?
Well, they're fairly easy to look after. I mean, this is just a temporary accommodation until he goes into the luxury accommodation here.
Look at that. Stalagluft. Right.
But the only other thing is that I'm afraid when they do a poo, it doesn't necessarily go straight down. It can go in any direction.
Oh, my goodness. Right. OK, and is it a fragrant poo?
It smells horrible, yes.
Oh, well, that's very nice indeed. So that's important to remember. This is our pet. We want to look after it properly, so we've nominated John, our top zookeeper. John, come on in. All right, John. So, John, have you a steady hand?
Yeah. He tried to say something earlier, but...
really?
Missed it. Yeah,
what was it? Was it something rude they learned from the crew?
It was kind of like,
Oh, it could be an oasis.
The start of great things.
Oh, fantastic. Well, that's good, John. And we entrust you with our lovely minor bird. Rob, thank you very much for coming in. And,
you're
of course,
welcome.
John, if you always want to pull, you can just get some of that fragrant poo up here. There we go.
Down.
Is that what it is?
Beautiful.
I wonder what that smells. Okay, now it's time for us to pop over to Richard. And now, of course, we met our family. We saw their wallpaper. We even saw Phil doing an outrageous celebrity strop. So let's see what he's up to now. So, Richard, how's the family and who's the family?
Cheers, Ricky, me old cocker. Yeah, it's the Turners. I mean, we're in Yorkshire. It's specifically Cleckheaton, isn't it?
Cleckheaton.
Yeah, very exciting. They're putting it on the map, aren't we, Di?
Eventually.
This is Di Turner. She's the mum of the family of the week. She's a single mother, a single parent, and we're actually in your bedroom at the moment, aren't we?
Yeah, yeah.
Do you want to give us a guided tour, as it were?
Well, this is my bed.
That's your bed. Oh, look at this. Oh. Bit of a nightie. This is a slinky little number. What were you up to last night?
Not a lot.
Not a lot, right. So you're after a bloke at the moment?
Now, there's half a bed to rent there. Oh, inquiries.
She is after a bloke. She is after a bloke. And notice as well, you're a bit of an old romantic here.
Yes,
look,
I am.
Here's your Catherine Cookson books. You've got loads of them, haven't you?
Yes.
And
yes.
Is that Mills and Boone at the bottom there? I just noticed.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Mills and Boone's.
Street
the village
cred,
vet.
Street
oh, very exciting. As he told her in his manly arms. Right, okay, what else have we got around here then? Look, lots of makeup as well, very nice. And it's all like hearts
and
prayers.
No polyfiller there at the moment.
No
I usually get polyfiller in
jeans. And a towel, yeah, to slap it on. I don't believe you. Don't believe you. Okay, let's take a wander over. Oh, actually, let's get in the wardrobes, because that's always quite exciting. No, reality. Let's have a look.
Nothing to wear.
Nice little suits, lovely. That's nice.
Nothing to wear.
Actually, it's usually the embarrassing stuff, so it's hidden in the corner. So where can we find the embarrassing stuff? This is pretty embarrassing.
Oh,
explain that, Di. What's that all about? Where'd you wear that to?
I'll probably have that on tomorrow.
You're going to tell me that's your best suit now, aren't you? All right, let's move on then. Let's go into... this is Phil's bedroom. This is Phil. He's the son. Oh, Phil. Actually, his son says, Phil, come on, mate. Up you come. Let's have a look at your room. What's it called? In you come. What's it called, this room?
We've nicknamed this the Swamp.
The Swamp. Let's find out why. Actually, it's quite tidy. I don't know why it's called the Swamp. What's it called the Swamp for?
I don't know.
It's usually not tidy. Oh, blimey, I just knocked your aerial over. I'm sorry, mate. It is untidy now. And look, he's got to... Oh, no, that's a write-off. You've got all these things up on the wall here, so you just stand around staring at these all the time, do you?
I got them yesterday.
Do what?
I got them yesterday.
Especially for us, yeah?
No.
No, okay, fair enough. Well, that's very nice. And look, there's a picture of him up on the wall as well. Oh, there's some more pictures in here. We'll go and look. In you come, Di. Let's have a quick look at the girls' room. Girls, in you come. Wendy and Catherine, this is their bedroom. Oh, bunk beds as well. So who's got the top bunk then, Wendy?
Catherine
has it. It's the best place. Best place, isn't it, really? And look, we've got Peter Andre on the wall. Just in case you forget who you are, pictures of you as well. When did you have those done?
On holiday.
In June. Oh, so it's quite recent.
Yeah,
and
I've never made in the morning, ever.
Oh, but especially ever. Done for us today. I noticed as well, you got Gary Barlow right in front of your pillow.
Oh.
First bloke you see when you get up in the morning.
He's gorgeous.
Oh dear, Gary Barlow. I'm not sure about this family. All right then, well, we'll take another look around the rest of the stairs later on in the week. We're going to be learning all about the Turner family, getting to know them, all the rest of it, uncovering a few secrets as well. It's going to be a good week. They're a great family. I'm really excited about it. It's back over to Rick and Sharron now.
I think, Richard, you ought to be doing bed duties to pay for your keep all week, you know, like making the beds for everybody all week.
Are they?
Make the beds. Oh, right, blimey. I'll tell you. I don't like this new show. You've got to get me to do all sorts of stuff. There we go.
There we go. Richard,
Thank you very much, Richard.
Bearing up. Head straight to the girls' bedroom. Okay. So let's take a look at our question of the day. Right. And we've been taking a look at some machinery here in the house that's gone a bit wrong. And things are going right.
Gizmos and gadgets.
Anything like that in your house that go wrong. So let us know about it. And I've got one here if you want.
Yeah, I've got one from Sue, who's from Carshalton. Mm. She says, my TV remote control seems to operate next door set as well. And everyone's getting very upset with her addiction to prisoner cell block H.
A mate of mine's got one of those watches that you can go into those electrical stores. You know, it's a remote control thing. He goes in and changes all the channels, turns the volume up and runs out, and they're like, oh, they can't do anything about it.
Nice mate.
Yeah, very nice, yeah. I've got lots of great friends. Alan Alana from Ayr in Scotland, hello. My Hoover blew instead of sucked the other day, spraying dust and packing in, for goodness sake. Spraying dust and dirt all over my prospective mother-in-law, who was round for tea. And mother-in-laws have this sort of uncanny knack to walk along and go, I see dust. Thank you for that. So if you'd like to get involved, then why don't you give us a call?
Yeah, coming up shortly, we've got superstar Andie Macdowell and that young, gorgeous, wealthy young man, Cole Crompton.
Ooh.
But with time at 8:16, here's a reason to be cheerful.
Yeah.
We'll be right back.
What's the nuttiest thing you've ever done?
I just nearly thought I was someone else. She's got this problem with her laugh. I nearly thought I was someone else. She laughs at anything.
You nuttiest sunbat!
Yes.
It's the nuttiest thing you've ever done. Payday is a crazy calendar game where you can be at the top of the world one day.
I've won a lottery!
And at the bottom of the barrel the next. And just when you think you know who's found their fortune...
Yes!
And who's lost their shirt, it can all change. Right up until...
Yes.
Payday.
Elaine Latham. I'm the artist that created Magic Dip just for you, and it will make you an artist too. I'm going to work with maybe three or four colors. I haven't made up my mind, and I guess that's the artist in me. So I am going to make a really nice design now. You're going to have so much fun. You are going to be going round and round, saying, what do I dip? What do I dip? You're going to get dipping fever. What a pair of sneakers. Here's a pussycat. Oh, well. This is more fun than anything you've ever done before in your life.
Are you in the know about Cheerios?
No, I like them.
What about nutrition?
Nutrition.
Corn, oats, rice, and wheat. For green nutrition and not too sweet.
What, in one cereal?
Yeah, but only in Cheerios.
You know that.
I know that.
Are you in the know about Cheerios?
Good morning.
What a wonderful day.
We danced the whole night through. Good morning to you. How do you do? Just say
I said good morning.
See the sun is shining.
A good morning.
Hear the birdies sing. It's great to stay up late. Good morning to you.
That reason to be cheerful was Babes in Arms, which is on Channel 4 this afternoon.
So there you go. And I've just done something I'm discussing. I've just chewed someone else's pen. Okay, so... oh, goodness. So let's find out what's coming up in the news later. Peter.
Rick. Home Secretary seems to have dropped another political bombshell by giving two drug barons early release from prison. There's another postal strike today in spite of a new pay and conditions offer. And £15 million man has given Moldova a mauling. All that and more on the half hour. But for now, it's back to the house.
Cheers for that, Peter.
Thank you very much.
Can you just say that again? Can you
all
say,
of it.
Can you say, Rick?
Rick.
Thank you.
Hello, Rick.
Now, back in March, Carl Crompton scooped a massive £10.9 million from the National Lottery.
Wow.
£10.9 million.
Huge.
And he's been recording the nitty-gritty on some videotapes for us, the first of which he did this weekend, so let's take a look at it.
Ooh. Hi, my name's Carl Crompton. 4 months ago, this was my life. Or my house, rather. I used to live here with my mum, my dad and my brother. I was never stuck for things to do, but I just didn't have the money to do it. Then, on May the 4th, around about 8 o'clock, my numbers came up. And this is my life now. And every week, we're going to be finding out how much fun you can have with £10.9 million. Well, slightly less, actually, because I've already bought my dad a Jeep, my brother a Porsche, my mum, a Vectra, and me, this rather nice Beamer. And I couldn't resist treating myself to a couple of things I've always wanted. My Suzuki and my dream Ducati, baby, baby. I also bought this rather nice house for my mum and dad. It's not bad, is it? This is my base at the moment, but not that I'm here very often. I mean, take last weekend, for example, I got invited to my first celebrity party in Barcelona. and that was a top 24 hours.
Hi, I finally arrived. It's a fantastic party, it's a fantastic place. I've only been here for half an hour and I've seen Daniela Westbrook, Pulp, Elastica, Danny Minogue. But money can buy you a few things, but it can't buy you friends in high places. So there's only one thing for it. I'm going to have to lower myself and mingle to all these people. See you later. Danny, hi, gorgeous babe.
So what's it all about? Or do you really want to know? Do you want to give up? Do you just want to take it all go? Cause you better let it out.
What a night. Italy had no rest for the wicked. In 7 hours, I had to get back on the plane, but not to go to bed, to go to my mate's 21st, because I'm still one of the lads, and that'll never change.
You door won't keep her hands off me.
I'm Cheryl. Me, Danny Minogue. Kathleen Lloyd. Daniela Westbrook. Two Spanish models, Sarah and Maria.
Watch it.
Stop. Oh, well, another day, another do. Who wants to be a millionaire, eh? Me. Hello? Ah, hola. I'll see you later. Maria, ¿cómo estás?
Oh, my goodness.
Well, I tell you what, let's meet him now, shall we? Because Carl Thompson is going to come into the house and tell us about being a millionaire. And I think you could see him arriving with a little bit of luck. And look, unaided by a bodyguard.
There he goes.
He's tall, he's strong, he's got lots and lots of money. And he's going to come in and tell us about it now on...
Well,
and the reason Carl's walking around is we've strict orders not to stand on this because he gets told off. Carl, welcome.
Yes,
welcome.
Rick,
to
hi.
The big breakfast.
Oh, sorry.
Hiya.
Jazz.
Jazz.
He's allowed to say anything he likes, just whatever you like, Carl, for money. Carl, what's it like being a millionaire?
Oh, I don't know. It's terrible. Terrible. Yeah. Nightmare.
What does it feel like? When you actually found out, I mean, could you just give us just a quick impression of when you actually found out, that exact moment? Can you just do what you
you
did?
Ah!
Oh,
there you go.
I see.
There you go.
Did you actually believe your numbers? Yes.
No.
Because I'm like looking
so often. Well, no, I didn't, because I had to... I checked on teletext, and I had to ring up as well to confirm. But when they did confirm him, I still didn't believe it. I was checking the date on the ticket and everything going. I picked up one from weeks ago. Brian.
Lordy, lordy, let's hope it works out right. Now, before we go on and talking a bit more about being a millionaire, you went on a bit of a posh weekend, didn't you?
I did, top.
A bit of a jolly. So tell
us
about
that. Very good, very good. Went down to Barcelona.
Yeah?
Went down
to Barcelona.
Just
nipped down
for the weekend.
Yeah. Caught the next plane.
Okay.
And met loads of people.
Now,
we've actually got
some photos of you meeting famous posh people.
Yes.
So let's have a look at this one. Now, this is your first. Talk us through this one. Now, this is Danny Minogue. Now, why have you got your hands in your pockets, mate?
Is that about to buy a ticket?
You checking your money there?
Yeah, because she tried to get it. She tried to get after my wallet and everything.
Well, there you go. Let's quickly go through this. And, look at that. Daniela Westbrook.
Wasn't me.
Was she nice?
Very nice, actually.
And look at this
one.
Hello!
Kathy!
Yay!
Yeah, I like Kathy Lloyd, don't I? Very nice. Yeah. Oh. Tell me, have you all of a sudden had 100 girlfriends come out of the woodwork and ring you up?
There's been a few. I've not read it in the papers. They're all slagging me off. It's great.
Oh. Well, you had one come out of the woodwork, didn't you? You had a girlfriend.
Sharron.
Ring you up.
Yeah.
Now that you're famous.
About 2 years ago.
Leave
Oops.
Him alone.
Oh, here we go. So there we go. So, Carl, you're going to be hanging around and giving us more reports as well. So, just if you were to go out just this morning, what would you buy? What would you spend $1 million on very
today.
Quickly this morning?
Very quickly. A house.
I
haven't got one yet.
Anywhere. Get into
you bought one for your mum and dad.
Bought one for mum and dad, yeah.
So nice of you.
I'm a sweet boy. Sweet boy.
So we look forward to your next diary, Carl. Thank you for popping in,
absolutely.
Sir. But now it's time for a reason to be cheerful.
Thunderbirds are go.
My name is Elaine Latham. I'm the artist that created Magic Dip just for you, and it will make you an artist too. I'm going to work with maybe three or four colors. I haven't made up my mind, and I guess that's the artist in me. So I am going to make a really nice design now. You're going to have so much fun. You are going to be going round and round, say, what do I dip? What do I dip? You're going to get dipping fever. What a pair of sneakers. Here's a pussycat. Oh, well. This is more fun than anything you've ever done before in your life.
To the rescue! Look out, Sally Strawberry! No problem, Rosie! Let's get a Munch Bunch!
Yes! Munch Bunch Pot Shots! Fruitalicious, that's what!
Well, what is going on here? I do declare you can't live on grass! What you need is a nutritious breakfast! There are 140 days of sunshine crammed into every box of Kellogg's Corn Flakes. So every bowl is full of sunshine. Cock-a-doodle!
Good old Cornelius.
Kick-start your day with Kellogg's Corn Flakes.
Destroy the atomic station in 1 3/4 hours. International Rescue, can you hear us? Are you receiving our message?
International Rescue to Saharan Station. We picked up your emergency call.
That's the situation, Father. If the reactor explodes, the radioactivity will do unthinkable damage.
Radio the station, John. Tell them help is on its way.
Like the Thunderbirds, we're not actually real. Because look, if you switch us off.
Wooden tops.
Okay, so of course Carl Crompton will be with us. What, you want to do it again?
Yeah.
Of course, Carl. Oh, you know.
What can I say?
It's not even on autocue. So there we are. Carl Crompton will be with us every Monday with his very special diary. And of course, that was the Thunderbirds, and you can see them at 6 pm on Bravo.
On the menu in the next 20 minutes. At 8.32, all the travel and weather in our area from Denise Van Outen in the Big Breakfast helicopter. At 8.40, Vanessa chats to Hollywood superstar Andie Macdowell. And at 8.45, you'll trust him, he's the Big Breakfast doctor.
Oh, so hopefully he's got warm hands. And now, with the time at 8.30, we must go over to Peter Smith for our Big Breakfast news. Peter, sir!
Good morning, these are the main stories on Monday the 2nd of September. More flack for Michael Howard as two heroin dealers have their sentences slashed. An 8th postal strike means letterboxes lie untouched again. And Shearer's bang on target as England's new skipper. The Home Secretary is still facing the music over his decision to release two heroin dealers from jail. John Hass and Paul Bennett had served just 12 months of an 18-year sentence. Michael Howard based his decision on a letter from the trial judge, which pointed out that the men had shocked other dealers. The parents of a loyalist hardliner have been the victims of a hand grenade attack on their home. Alex Kerr has received death threats along with Billy Wright because of fears they want to break the ceasefire. Kerr's parents escaped serious injury. Police searching for 4-year-old Tom Lachlan, who vanished from a beach in Norfolk, are trying to identify a boy's body found nearby. Tom disappeared 2 weeks ago with his sister Jodie. She was found drowned on Friday. Postal deliveries will be delayed again today as unions stage their 8th 24-hour stoppage. Letters will have built up from last Friday's strike. Managers are angrily attacking the union for not holding a fresh ballot on a new pay and conditions offer. Kim Wilde is waking up to a new life as Mrs. Fowler. The 35-year-old married Tommy co-star Hal Fowler in Hertfordshire yesterday. The couple are honeymooning somewhere in Britain. They say they're keen to start a family, but better be quick because they're back on stage on Friday. Doctors from 47 European countries are calling for a smoking ban on all aircraft. The British Medical Association says there's no such thing as a smoke-free area on a plane because the air is recycled. The England squad arrived home in the early hours, fresh from victory in their World Cup opener against Moldova. New coach Glenn Hoddle and new skipper Alan Shearer will be delighted with the 3-0 scoreline. Shearer got the third goal, but Hoddle says he knows the team are capable of better things. Scientists may not be certain, but thousands who do believe in ET are phoning home from Los Angeles. They came from as far afield as Croatia for the 54th World Science Fiction Convention, or WorldCon, as it's known by its critics. It's 8:32. We're back at 9. Here's Rick and Sharron.
Did you see your mum there, Pete?
That wasn't
thank
very
you
nice,
very much.
Was it?
Sorry.
Will not
I'll
be pleased.
Slap it for you.
I'm sorry.
Don't
I'm
worry,
sorry.
Peter.
Oh my
thank
goodness.
You.
Mrs. Smith. Sorry. Okay. We'll see you later, Peter. But now it's time for us to go high in the sky. It's very exciting. It's our brand new way of bringing you the weather and the travel together. So we're going up for our eye in the sky for the Big Breakfast helicopter.
Denise, where are you?
Hi, I'm in Newcastle. I'm just hovering at 2,300 feet over Newcastle city centre. Now, the weather here at the moment is actually improving. It's getting much better throughout the morning. The clouds do seem to be moving away, but it's still a little bit chilly. But the temperatures in the rest of the country are looking like this. There'll be an average of 20 degrees, ranging from 18 degrees in Glasgow and Belfast to 22 degrees in Plymouth. As for the chance of rain, well, in Glasgow, they've got a 60% chance of rain, and in Cardiff, it's going to be a dry day. And the outlook, it's another mixed bag. We've got northwest Scotland is going to be cloudy with drizzle. In the east, it will also be cloudy. In southwest England and South Wales, they're going to have quite a nice day. It'll be warm with some sunshine. In North Wales, Northern Ireland and Southern England, it's going to be dry and warm with cloud. And now I have a Big Breakfast fascinating fact for you. Did you know that a guy called Gladstone Adams, who was a local photographer, was born here in Newcastle, invented the windscreen wiper? And Rick and Sharron, here's one we prepared for you earlier. Check this out. Well done, Knight. Now the traffic, we're just hovering over the A16M7M. And at the moment, it seems to be moving quite well. It did seem to be getting more congested throughout the morning. But the traffic's been pretty good here in Newcastle overall. Now, in the rest of the country, the A406 in London, there is a broken-down lorry which is causing delays at Staples Corner. And the A46 between Bath and Cold in Somerset has an accident which has closed both carriageways and is causing major, major tailbacks. And the M25, there is an accident in the roadworks clockwise between junctions 9 and 10. This is causing serious delays, and of course, roadworks will continue. And the A90 in Edinburgh, which is the Queen's Ferry Road, there are serious delays westbound due to a broken down lorry. Well, that's it from me, Denise Van Outen, about the eye in the sky. Back to Rick and Sharron. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Denise. And you're hovering over Newcastle, so you're our YI in the sky. YI.
YI.
Cheers
for that. I'm the time.
Look who we're with.
Hey, I've got Carl.
And
my man.
Do you mind if I put my arm around you?
I don't.
Or do you have to have a lawyer present? Right. That's okay. Andie Macdowell. Wow, it's great to have her here. Now it's time to take a look at our next. Actually, just a minute. Weren't you in Planet of the Apes, Andie?
No, I wasn't.
Oh, that's Roddy Macdowell. I'm sorry. Okay. So let's take a look at our next big thing. I'm sorry. Now, the next big thing, what could it be? Every time this week we're going to be looking at something you shouldn't be without. Now, what is it? Could it be, this, Aborex? It's actually a breath elixir that not only picks you up, but also makes your breath fresh. So, would you like to try it, Andie? I mean, you've got lovely fresh oil. No, that's not fair. You've got lovely breath. So
what are you saying? What are you saying?
All right, calm, mate. Come on, you need it for those celebrity hangovers. Okay. Slap it in your... Slap it on your tongue. Go on.
Just a few drops.
Okay, go on. Give him a snog, then.
Great.
Miss Al.
Oh, what's that? Yeah, okay.
Or, sort of £1 million worth of breath, though.
It could be that. Or is it this? It's a new album from Suede. It's called Coming Up. I think it's fantastic. It's a bit of a winner. And, of course, Trash, their single, went in at number 3 this week. And this album is released today, so let's have a listen to it. Is it ready to play? Did you cue this up, Drew? Oh, there. So that's Trash. That's very nice. And the next one, I can't actually... Oh, I can't change channel. I can't see. But anyway, the next track on that's very good. Sounds like David Bowie.
I bet you were like that when you were a kid, weren't you? You played your music really loudly.
Of course I did. Of course
irritated
did.
Your poor parents.
So there we are. There's a TV from Suede. Now, is it that? Well, it's not, actually, because the thing that you shouldn't be without, the next big thing, is marmalade ice cream.
No!
So, Andie, would you like to try some?
No, thank you.
Okay, all we could do, of course, is just to make it even more fragrant. Have you got that elixir there? Can you give me that elixir? Yeah. We could actually put that in as a wafer and then add this as well, just a bit of a pick-me-up, which is very nice. Just try that. Rock and roll breakfast. All right. Actually, this is marmalade, isn't it?
Of course it is. That's why it's called marmalade ice cream.
Would you like to slice some toast?
Oh, I'd love to.
So, have you got some toast?
I'd love to.
See, Andie, this is proper English toast.
Yeah, wobbly stuff.
There we go. So, slap some on there, Sharron, and tell us what you think of that.
There we go. Hang on. I need a knife, really, don't I? Yeah, it's actually out today. You can rush out and buy some. It's in the shops. And actually, Carl said he would love to do this.
No, I tried a little bit.
Oh, you really? Okay.
I think things we do.
I'll try if you like. Oh, okay. Can I try a bit as well? Fantastic. Well, that's really interesting. I think I'll just stick with Marmaid, actually. But there we are. Now, Andie, of course, is here. Now, Andie, you're going to be talking to Vanessa a little bit later in her boudoir about your latest film, which is called Multiplicity, isn't it?
Yeah.
And are you very excited about your new film?
Yeah, it's great. I love it. It's very funny.
Anything she says is just wonderful. Okay, so Multiplicity. That's going to be a screening around the country on Sunday, the 22nd of September. But hey, would you like to go and see it?
Yeah.
Let's find out how you can. Number you've got to call, and an exclusive chance for Big Breakfast viewers to go and see Multiplicity and Andie Macdowell completely and utterly for free, which is good news. Okay, so the time is now 8:38, looking underneath Carl's armpit. So stand by soon, because Vanessa will be chatting to Andie Macdowell.
Vanessa's little helpers.
I know, I'm late, and I haven't even done my hair yet.
Head and Shoulders is pH balanced, and it's mild enough to use every day.
Now, I'm really late.
Should you look under the lid of a tin of Felix this month to find you've won an instant £100,000, please remember one thing, and that's why you opened the tin in the first place.
Sorry, Felix.
That way, everybody gets a fair share of the goodies.
It's not easy keeping your hands clean and fresh. Every day they pick up all kinds of hidden germs, the kind some normal soaps find hard to handle. Thank goodness for Carex. While its antibacterial formula combats germs and odours, Carex gently moisturises. Very nice. So, after every little job, make sure your hands are Carex clean.
Hefty Hipper was trying for the world's highest dive. When he got to the top, he changed his mind. Only one thing for this, Kellogg's Cocoa Pops. So I filled the swimming pool with Cocoa Pops to the brim. When he saw the milk turn chocolatey, he dived right in. Oh, yeah! Only Kellogg's Cocoa Pops has cocoa's magic secret. So it looks and tastes magic as part of a nutritious breakfast. I'd rather have a bowl of Cocoa Pops.
What's the nuttiest thing you've ever done? Nope! You nuttiest sunbat! It's the nuttiest thing you've ever done!
Why not half exchange your old house for a stunning new Barrett home? For details, call Barrett on 0345-626364.
Hello. Every morning I'm going to be helped by an expert about something. Tomorrow it's going to be Kate Chaplin. She's a beauty journalist. She's going to tell us everything we need to know to look even more gorgeous. But today I'm far too busy to be bothered with those sort of fripperies, because I'm here with someone who already looks gorgeous, Andie Macdowell, one of Hollywood's hottest properties. You are here. Everyone's just... Oh my gosh, she looks just how she really looks. You look so much like yourself. You look brilliant. You're here. Will you look?
Because
some
That's
people
amazing,
look.
Isn't
no,
it?
Some people look better on films with clever lighting and lots of. Isn't that true? And you don't. You just look good in any old lighting. You look amazing.
Thank
you're
you.
Here because of Multiplicity, a new film.
Yes.
And we're going to see just a little clip of what all the fuss is all about. Let's see it.
Just what are you saying?
Laura, this whole system isn't working. It's just not working. It's a dismal failure. We have to go back to the way it worked. You stay and take care of the house, which you do really well, and I have to do what I need to do.
Oh, and what do you need to do?
Laura, I gotta go back to work, and that's it.
No, actually, that's not it. I love my job, and so far, I'm doing great at it. In fact, Valerie said if I keep it up, she's going to move me into a state, so very soon, I could be making a very good living. Now, I know this is hard for you, and I can imagine the kind of day that you've had, but I am not quitting. So we are just going to have to work all this out, and that is it.
You told him?
Yes, yes.
That is it,
yes.
You said. A crusading feminist, but in a light comedy.
Yes, it's very funny.
It's all about cloning.
Well, yeah, that's a big part of it, yes. And I don't know about it, but my husband has cloned himself.
And that's all because of the pressures of modern living and...
Right, right.
Incredibly difficult to do all you've got to do. He wants to be a good husband, a good lover, a hard worker.
Right.
And therefore he has to
be there for the kids and be successful. And, yeah.
And do you feel a bit like that yourself? Because you're
yes,
here with
I do.
Me, I bet
I
you'd rather be at home.
And well, I could use a clone. I'd like to be here with you, but I'd also like to be with my kids.
Because you're one of life's warriors.
Well, I just, I guess I'm an overachiever, perhaps.
But you always feel that when you're at work, you should be with the kids, and when you're with
right,
the kids, you should
right,
be at work.
Right, right, right. Well, I think a lot of women have that problem.
Michael Keaton plays four characters in the film.
Yes.
Was this difficult to adjust to, watching him slide in and out?
No, it was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun. And as far as, my participation, it was a good kick. I mean, the scene where I get to sleep with all of them,
Well, you mentioned that. I wasn't going to bring up sex at this time of the morning, but it is true to say that you rapaciously had carnal knowledge of all four clones in one night.
Well, actually, it was only the three. I did everybody but my husband.
I think you did him earlier on in the film. You looked exhausted by the end of that film. I mean, does that reflect your normal sorts of appetites, that kind of behaviour?
Well...
From what I've read, your husband, former male model that you met on a fashion shoot, is quite prudish about the roles that you play.
Oh, not really. I mean, it's understandable. I don't really think he's prudish. He's actually
he's not
he's
watching.
Very
you
accepting.
Can say whatever you like about him.
No, he's not. He's really. I don't think he's prudish. I just think he's like any man. It's a hard situation to
but
watch.
If you'd
someone
said,
that you love, be very intimate.
But if you said,
I'm doing
Basic Instinct and I'm going to cross my legs, what would you have said?
I wouldn't do Basic Instinct, though.
You wouldn't want to?
No.
But he is quite... I mean, you do discuss it with him, he does say.
Well, we discuss it. He wouldn't hold me back from something I truly believed in, because I think he trusts my taste as well.
How do you know, just looking at the script of a film on the page, whether it's going to be a hit or not? Did you realise that Four Weddings and a Funeral was going to be great?
Because Four Weddings and a Funeral was one of the best scripts I ever read. I mean, Richard Curtis is just... He's he's got his own style. He's just amazing. I mean, I read it, and it was just, I laughed. I had a great time. It was I never put it down. I read it from beginning to end. I couldn't put it down. It was a great script.
And lest anybody think you're an empty-headed model, you took a percentage of the profit of that film.
I did it for not very much money, but I had some good advice.
That was quite, that was an original sort of deal to strike, wasn't it?
It was great, because at the time I had been offered another film for 10, 20 times more than what I had been offered for Four Weddings, but I wanted to do Four Weddings because it was great. And I turned the other one down, and my business manager asked me what in the hell I was doing. But he didn't know what I knew.
And you knew, and you made so much money, you could afford to take a year off work and have another baby.
That's right.
Of which, more later, we're going to find out all about Snogging Hugh Grant and what it was really like, because we really want to know. But coming up after the break, much more with Andie Macdowell. But stand by now for our brand new Big Breakfast Doctor.
Join Captain Stage Right at his book Buccaneers for the new Huggies treasure hunt. Because all pirates know, nothing keeps your skin drier than Huggies. So all aboard for a dry landing. Now Huggies have a unique stretchy fastening system. The only nappies with fastener tabs from Velcro USA Inc. Even with oily hands, they always refasten. Treasure ahoy!
Huggies!
There's no drier nappy on the seven seas.
Jigsaw puzzles took our world and always made it flat. This is what DuPont 3D is doing about that. It's going up.
Puzz 3D, the three-dimensional puzzle that's challenging every inch of the way.
Puzz 3D, it's going up.
New Puzz 3D.
What's the nuttiest thing you've ever done? You nutty something! It's the nuttiest thing you've ever done!
You know why I always have Tic Tac with me? Simple. Because one tiny Tic Tac refreshes my breath for 2 hours, and Tic Tac has only 2 calories. So I can have 2 hours of Tic Tac freshness in just 2 calories. Great, huh?
Tic Tac. 2 hours of freshness in just 2 calories.
Thanks, Mum. Okay, first question for us.
Dairy Slice.
Name the capital city of France.
Paris.
Correct. The second question for you, Sam.
Name Postman Pat's
cat.
Never seen it.
Even for a Dairy Slice.
Jess.
Kids will do anything for a Dairy Lee slice.
Why not part exchange your old house for a stunning new Barrett home and get 100% of its market value? Barrett Premier Collection homes offer more choice, more style and more features than ever before. And for just £99 down, first-time buyers can move into a fabulous brand-new Barrett home with expenses paid. For details, call Barrett on 0345 62 63 64. The lines are open now.
A is for acne or teenage spots. Now don't believe the myths. It's not because you eat too much chocolate or chips or because you're dirty. It's simply caused by the male hormone testosterone, which you produce around the time of puberty. Don't squeeze your spots. That'll just make them scarred and infected. Instead, here are a few things you can try. Hygiene. Just wash with soap and water. That's enough. Go and see your pharmacist, who can recommend some creams that you can use. These will unblock the pores and get the skin looking good again. Or if things are really bad, go and see your doctor. By using long-term hormones or antibiotics, he can really clear up most bad skins or even refer you on to hospital. Tomorrow, B is for bad breath.
That was Dr. Mike Ingram. There's going to be more of him tomorrow. He wears the best ties in the whole of North London, I must tell you that. He was talking about spots. Have you ever suffered from anything normal like spots? Zits, the sort of squeezable kind?
Oh, not really. I've been very fortunate in that area.
Very fortunate in lots of it. What about your hair? Is it naturally that curly? You look like the person after they've applied the treatment stuff.
Yeah, it's just curly.
It's just a wash and go kind of style?
It's very curly. It's odd, though. You know, as a little girl, I had straight hair.
Did you?
Mm-hmm.
So you could grow up to be Andie Macdowell. Anything could happen. Tell us about Hugh Grant. I mean, nobody knew that he was a world-renowned sex symbol at that stage. But did you realize?
Oh, yeah, I thought he was really cute. I thought he was great. And that's what I told the director in the beginning of the movie. I said, this is going to be really easy.
And was Liz Hurley hovering around in the background then?
She came by a couple of times. She wasn't hovering around, but she dropped by.
But this was before that dress.
You know, the dress with the safety pins, the Versace dress that made her entire career?
Do you think that's what did it?
Yes, I do. Never before has an entire career been based upon one very little dress. Did you see that she was a raving beauty and could have a £1 million contract later, or was she just blended in with the crowd?
Oh, I thought she was really beautiful.
Are you going to say anything horrible about anybody now?
Not if I can help it.
When Hugh Grant reached his debacle on Sunset Boulevard in that incident that we won't go into, you replied, nothing could possibly be as bad as being dubbed by Glenn Close.
I think I wrote him a note. I don't know if he ever got it. And I said it could be worse. I said you could have been dubbed by Glenn Close.
Was it really awful being dubbed by Glenn Close?
Oh.
Just to fill everybody in, this was your very first film.
It was such a long time ago that now it's a joke for me.
It was Greystoke, and you did the whole film, and then they dubbed in her voice because they felt you couldn't get the English accent right.
Right.
Which we feel very insulting because she's not even English anyway.
No.
So you had to kind of swallow some kind of humiliation and just kind of target your career in a different direction, did you?
Yeah, but maybe, you know, I'm the kind of person that take something like that and thinks if that hadn't have happened, maybe perhaps I wouldn't have achieved what I've done, and maybe, you know, you have to look at things like that maybe it was for the best.
Have you ever met Glenn Close?
I don't know if we've ever been properly introduced. I've seen her before, and she has sent scripts that have has shown interest in working with me and things like that. So I don't really have anything against her. I think she's a wonderful actress.
You're just not going to say anything nasty, just definitely, whatever I do. You don't live in Hollywood, though, so you can't think it's all gorgeous. You live in Montana on a ranch.
Right, I do, yeah.
Just tell us about your animals.
I have chickens and pigs, and my son, I talked to my husband, he shot a skunk just the other day.
Skunk? Is that some kind of rite of passage?
We had a skunk. Slightly, I think.
That makes him a man now. You're a man, my son. You shot the skunk.
Yeah, but we've had a real skunk problem. But I think that was the fourth or fifth skunk we've killed in the last 2 weeks.
Oh, that's a great achievement. I'm very glad you decided to share that with us. That's fantastic. I was going to hear about the horses and the dogs.
I have horses, dogs, yes. I have those too. Cows.
Cows. Mm-hmm. Cows. You just saw
lots of wild animals too.
You saw the ranch, and then your husband camped in a teepee on the site while it was being renovated.
He did.
Was that a bit extreme? Why did he do that?
Well, because he didn't have any place else to live, and it was so far out, to come back and forth would have been really hard, and he was, like, devoted. He was into it. He got into it for that year. I don't think he'd want to ever do it again.
Is he a classic house husband?
No, he's not. People like to kind of, like, label him as that, but he has his own business.
But he gives the kids their cereal in the morning and drives them to school?
He participates. I mean, I think we're equals, which I think is healthy. I don't think there's one of us that... And a lot of people find that hard to accept, but I think we do both... We're just equals. We both work and we both take care of the kids. And he's a better cook than I am. And there are things that, you know, that I do better than he does. He never cleans the closet or straightens the drawers. And he doesn't have any idea about what's going on in the kids' room. I mean, I do those things. But he is a better cook than I am.
But his virility is not undermined by the fact that you're earning the big billions and he's not.
No. He's very secure in his creativity and what he brings to the kids' lives.
Next up, we're going to see you in a film with John Travolta.
Yes.
Called Michael.
Yes.
How's he looking?
Great. I think he did a wonderful job in this movie. I just saw it the other day. It's really good.
It's been brilliant to meet you. Thank you so much indeed for coming in. Andie Macdowell. And now over to Peter Smith for the final Big Breakfast news.
Closing headlines. The bodies of two British climbers have been recovered from a mountain in Pakistan a fortnight after they were killed by an avalanche. Stephen Thornley and Andrew Bowes were in their 20s. Home Secretary Michael Howard has defended his decision to allow the early release of two heroin dealers. John Haas and Paul Bennett had served only 12 months of their 18-year sentences. They were freed early, having grasped on other traffickers. There's been a hand grenade attack on the home of the parents of loyalist hardliner Alex Kerr. He and Billy Wright have had death threats because of fears they plan to break the ceasefire. Mr. Kerr's parents escaped serious injury. There's another post-strike today. Managers are furious that union leaders won't hold a fresh ballot on pay and conditions. Further strikes could trigger a 3-month suspension of the Royal Mail's monopoly. There's a new collection at Copenhagen Zoo. Homo sapiens on the inside of the cage. Melanie Botoft and Henrik Lehmann have been added to the collection. They'll spend 3 weeks inspiring visitors to reconsider their own lives. That's it from us. We'll see you tomorrow.
Thanks very much,
Peter.
Oh, we'll enjoy getting up that early again and seeing you all over again tomorrow morning.
Yes.
But now
I'm being as nervous.
Absolutely. Now it's time for the very latest, and it's our last ever weather update. But don't panic, because Denise will be here every day this week bringing the news from the telecopter. So let's go up to our eye in the sky way over Newcastle for the Big Breakfast Telecopter. Mm-hmm.
Denise, for the last time today, where are you?
I'm just hovering 2,000 feet above Newcastle, home of Newcastle United, and beautiful gardens like these. Well, actually, earlier on, I managed to pick you a flower because we nipped down there, and I got you this, Rick and Sharron. Now, the weather here in Newcastle seems to be much better. It's clearing a lot. The temperatures in the rest of the country will be an average of 20 degrees, ranging from 18 degrees in Glasgow and Belfast to 22 degrees in Plymouth. Chances of rain? Well, in Glasgow has a 60% chance of getting wet, and Cardiff and Plymouth will remain dry. The outlook? Well, it's another mixed bag. In northwest Scotland, it's going to be cloudy with some drizzle. In the east, it's also cloudy. Northwest England and South Wales should have a nice, dry, warm day with some sunshine. North Wales, Northern Ireland and Southern England is going to be a dry, warm day with cloud. That's back to Rick and Sharron. I'll see you tomorrow when I'll be in Edinburgh.
Here we go. So there we go. Thank you very much, Denise.
Have you had a good time today? You look like you have.
Oh, it's been fantastic. Nigel and I have had a ball, haven't we, Nigel?
Yeah, you put that Nigel down, all right?
Now, we've had Carl telling us as well. We believe you have his telephone number.
That was quick. I did not. I wouldn't do a thing like that.
Very fast work, my goodness.
Well, she's a sensible girl.
Sure, she is. Yeah.
Well, we'll see you tomorrow. Thank you very much, Denise.
See you tomorrow.
Now, of course, we had our phone-in question of the day. Where is it? No, it's gone. Oh, thank you. That was it. That was very good.
That was a little whistle.
That was so much as a trouser burst. Okay, and basically we were finding about the technical problems like that one, that's actually happened to you. So what have you got, Sharron?
And we've had absolutely loads, and I know lots of people have been ringing in, and we've not been able to mention everyone because we've been so busy, so don't not ring in tomorrow. I've got one from Andrew Cronsbin from Portsmouth. Came in one night, a little bit worse for wear, and changed every bulb in the house before he remembered about the fuse box.
Now, I don't know if it's happened to you, Vanessa, but Noel in Swansea had a bit of a problem with his Hoover because it was making strange noises, so he opened it up and he found his son's pet hamster.
Happens most days.
Was it?
I've got gerbils, rabbits, you know.
And that's how they power it. There's a little hamster inside powering it. Yeah. Like that.
So, I can relate to that very much. What's the next one? I'm sure it's happened to me.
My mum's cassette player played the one side of a tape forward and the other side in reverse at the same time, so like New Age music.
And then a hamster crawled out.
That's from Paula Brooks. Thank you very much from Bolton. Okay, so later on, and tomorrow's show, we have...
Yes. Well, we've got Vanessa. You'll be talking to that wonderful BBC Martin Bell.
Any minute he's going to push me in this van. I'm edging further forward all the time. Martin Bell's going to be here.
I think we're going to be doing fitness with pants tomorrow, would you believe?
So you have to stay tuned for that one. Thank you very much indeed to Annie McDowell.
Thank you very much, Carlos. Okay. You're going to be back next Monday with us as well, aren't you?
Yes.
With a new story?
New story.
Okay, that's it. We've got to say goodbye now from the big breakfast. We'll see you tomorrow morning. Bye-bye.